Redo of Healer Volume 8, Chapter 1, The Healer Refuses. Part 1. I overexerted myself yesterday, mainly mentally. I still feel drunk from all the emotions and memories stuffed inside of my head. Sadly, I don't have time to be resting. There are too many things I need to do since they already had the advantage of making the first move. If I stop moving now, there would never be any way to catch up in the future. I woke up and got changed into my day clothes. Glenn, who was sleeping next to me, was still sleeping soundly. She did a great job last night, so I'll let her sleep well for today. With Glenn's help, I was able to figure out that the important people in this kingdom are still untouched by the black power. This situation, which should give me relief, actually scares me. If the situation was that Brett couldn't do it yet and he doesn't have the power to bring the black power into this country, then everything is okay. But if the fact is that he doesn't even need to bother with this country, then our current situation is the worst. I need to prepare so that I can cope with the worst case scenario. While I was deep in thought, the door opens. Standing by the doorway is Setsuna in her underwear. That's too bad. It seems that Kiruga-sama is empty right now. I can't give you my morning service if it's like this, Setsuna said as she looked down sadly at my lower body. Sorry about that. I kept going a bit too late into the night. I'll make sure to spoil you later this afternoon. I hug and kiss Setsuna while saying this. Since she's my favorite, I need to do at least this much. Okay, I'll look forward to it. Okay then. I'll be going to Ellen's room, but what will you do? I'll follow you because I think there's something I can do to help too. Yeah, sounds good. It's better if you're next to me. Okay. Setsuna immediately collects the clothes outside the door and changes into them. It appears that she took off her clothes right in front of the door just for me. She must have done it since she knows that it excites me when she appears in her underwear. When Setsuna and I reach Ellen's room, we see that she is already working hard on the paperwork at her desk with Keare at her side. Our next battle is not just a battle of force, it's a war of information and politics of other countries too. I can't afford to lose Ellen at such a dire time. To make sure of this, I made Keare sleep in the same room as her. Don't push yourself too hard, Ellen, I say to her. Kiruga-sama is working hard, so I need to work hard too. Thanks to Kiruga-sama, I do not need to doubt the important people inside of this kingdom. Thankfully, I can think of a few paths we can take. That sounds promising. These are the possible movements that Brett might take that I have thought up. She hands me a single sheet from a large stack of papers on the edge of her desk. This one paper is probably just a summarized version of all the calculations and research that she had done. It's interesting, the emphasis is on Brett's ability, the ability of the Empire of Grandsbark, the surrounding environment, political factors, and above all, the human mind. This is the power of a feared genius who was once a military genius. At this rate, Brett will take over the world in 3 months' time. Yes, currently, the only power we have that can fight against their black power is the power that Kiruga-sama and Glenn wields. In just a few hours' time, the number of people infected will grow, and as we saw before, ordinary people will suddenly turn into monsters. If this happens in every country, then all the other countries will be suspicious of the neighboring countries and will be destroyed from the inside. Ellen says, with a voice laced in worry. What she said is correct. That power is indeed too terrifying. No matter how we move, we are still at a disadvantage. They can continue to expand their power with the black power, but we can't even increase the amount of people who can purify it. Time is not on our side in this war, I say, feeling dejected. We need to stay cautious at all times. After all, our opponent is Brett the Gun Hero. A black monster that is stronger than a black knight, has great battle power, excels in command ability, and information warfare that commands it. Troublesomeness cannot be expressed in words. If I had the power to beat a few of those monsters, I would have already defeated Brett. I knew that I couldn't, so I ran away. The more I think about it, the more my mind gets messed up. So what do you think we should do, Ellen? I ask. It might be impossible to win with human power. I can't think of many things that can make us win, but there are definitely some ways to win. Even if the possibility is slim, it is still a possibility. That's all we need. To borrow the power from Eve. In the first place, that black power was given to the King of Jeril from the previous Demon King. That is the power that the Demon King uses. Eve should have a higher control over it than Brett. Ellen suggests. I'm surprised she noticed that too. I only knew because I had used Recovery Heal on the Demon King. That power is a power that makes the Demon King go mad and crazy, but it is still the Demon King's power nonetheless. If it's Eve, then she can most likely use the same power. But that means Eve was attacked by black power. If someone deliberately uses that power, they will go mad like the predecessor Demon King, and eventually, Eve will not be Eve and will become a Demon King in a true sense. There is also one more thing, borrowing the power of the godbird Caladrius. If you are a godbird, you might know something about the black power. On the contrary, even a countermeasure for the black power could be found. It might be able to make a disease that even kills it, because Glenn the God Beast can kill it. We're going to need to rely on Eve a lot, huh? Part 2. Yes, she's one of our best assets we can get to counter our opponents. I cannot deny her words. But that's a method that I don't want to use. If we make Eve use the black power and win, Eve gets corrupted and the godbird will take lives. Eve has already used the godbird's power twice. There is no guarantee that she will survive the third time. There is also the chance that she would be reduced to a vegetable. I can't afford to do this because Eve is very important to me. She is my lover. What other ways are there? There are two other ideas that I thought of. The first one is where we bet using Kiruga Nisama's life. And even then the chances of succeeding are low. That man is obsessed with you and we can only let you get captured and find a chance to kill him as he uses you as a toy. That's a good plan. It'd be easy to create a one-on-one situation with him if we do that. Yes. But we are talking about Brett here. He should have already seen through this plan by now and is probably ready to accept it with open arms. He must have already placed countermeasures and in the worst case scenario. No, if a miracle doesn't happen, then Kiruga Nisama will be his toy for the rest of his life. So if a miracle doesn't occur, I'll definitely lose. And even if do win, I'll lose things of great importance to me. But the trade-off might be worth it if I win. Tell me the second option now. Yes. In truth, even our current situation has a 90% chance of us losing, so I feel like it is best to just return the Chabu die. I'm not too sure since it's so abstract. Kiruga Nisama's recovery heal has too many functions and advantages that I feel like it is not a recovery heal anymore. It's quite strong. Of course, it's my power after all. So, that's why I thought to think outside of the box. What if we choose to heal the world itself and rewind time? I was surprised. I was surprised because she reached the same conclusion that I reached in my first life. It is certainly possible in theory, but it is only theoretical. Even at our current level, we cannot take out that much power. You do have the necessary power. You just need to use the Philosopher's Stone as Brett did. If you have that, will you use Recovery Heal? Since the Philosopher's Stone was taken away, isn't it too troublesome? Isn't there something similar that you can use? Ellen asks casually. Are you talking about Eve? The current Demon King Eve Rhys. If you kill her you can get it. No. If it's Kiruga Nisama, you should be able to sneak attack her anytime you want. That's a bit too much. I know. I too do not want to do this since I see her as a friend. But I think that as soon as you use Recovery Heal she will return back to life and you can kill Brett and everything would be okay. Seeing Ellen smiling like that while she said it, I knew full well at that time that she was Princess Norn's sister. As a Genesis she would choose the best decision no matter what. Even if it wasn't the morally right decision. I won't do that. I said firmly. You mean you won't? It's not that you can't. Yeah. I won't use the Godbird's power, but I'll at least listen to what the Godbird wants to say, and then we'll continue planning. Let's start the process of putting me out as bait. Are you sure? I'm pretty sure you're gonna regret it later. Yes, I'm sure. Since there's a possibility, I'll bet on that slim chance. If that is your decision, then I will go along with it. I don't want to lose my memories of my time, you, Kiruga Nisama. Ellen says, smiling. Surprisingly, Ellen agreed instantly to the plan where the only success would happen if a miracle occurs. It's quite strange, it's surprising that Ellen will do something like give up on her duty as a soldier and agree to something like this. If it was the Ellen I knew, then she would have tried really hard to convince us otherwise. I'll do my best to even up the possibility of us winning by so little as to 1%. I say, with conviction. Yes, please do. Ellen says, cheerfully. I pushed down the suspicious feeling that rises inside my heart. Perhaps there is something that she is hiding from me. It is impossible that she would betray me because I made it that way. No matter what she does in the end, it would be to aid me. Since the decision has been made, I won't butt in and say anything else. I'll leave this to Ellen and just work on things that I can. Chapter 2. The Healer Struggles. Part 1. As soon as I left Ellen's side, I was left alone. I left Setsuna with Ellen because I really wanted some time to think alone. I was thinking about the most beautiful place inside the Dyral Kingdom. The flower garden that Queen Flare created, already losing her, as expected of a top-class soldier. She said to me, "Now I understand what she was saying. We're already losing miserably in this war. Even if we go all out in this war starting now, we will still lose in some parts of the war. From here on out, we can only rely on the enemy's blunders and our miracles. It's not wise to rely on miracles, and it's close to impossible for Brett to make a mistake. In all truth and honesty, the best plan would be the plan Ellen proposed, to kill Eve. Use the Godbird's power and win it all in the end." She also pointed out that by turning back time, Eve can be brought back. I know all of that, but my heart screams at me for even considering it. If follow through with this plan, I would cease to be myself. My emotions are starting to put brakes on my actions. But it would be meaningless to remove those brakes because those emotions represent me. I plan to make my own ideal world in a way that I can agree with. That is why I won't throw in Eve as a sacrifice. I'm going to need to keep this in the back of my mind. Depending on the future, I might not have the option of thinking such nice thoughts. If I mess up, I won't be able to just be left as a toy for Brett. I'm sure that Brett would injure and humiliate my women to make sure that he takes away everything important from me to break me. That's the kind of bastard he is. I don't think I would be able to take it if I saw my lovers, toys and my property being treated like that. If this kind of thing happened in the future, I wonder what I would be able to do. Within that day, I made all the preparations and prepared for the departure. I made sure to make love to Ellen and Keare as much as I could the day before. I made sure to not use contraception because both of them wished it so. I'm not sure if it would work, but I just thought to leave it as is. If it works, it works. I then departed to go to what may be my last battle ever. There are two things that take top priority. First, is to return Prince Caster to his home country, in Ritter Kingdom. He has the job of spreading the word around of what occurred at Grandspark Empire. We need to be the ones to do this because we are the only ones who can ensure his safety and still make it there fast. Secondly, I need to find Eve and gain the support of the Demon King and the Magic Beasts. We also need to get the knowledge of the God Bird. This is another thing that we need to do ourselves. The best course to take would be through the Inritter Kingdom and straight to the Demon King. Good luck, Iruganisama. Ellen said as her voice was filled with sadness. Sorry about this, Ellen. I can't afford to take you with me. You're needed here the most. It's okay, I understand that fully. Even though I made it so that this country would function without me here, there was no point of me doing that if I couldn't stick with Iruganisama. That's not true. Because you made it so that the country could function so well, we have a better chance of contending against Brett with your help. I'm happy that you're praising me, but if you say it like that, I have no way to complain anymore. Seeing Ellen pout, I found it hard to see her as the best soldier in the country. Sorry for asking you to be her escort, Keare. You don't need to apologize. I'm rather happy that I can be of an aid to you, Iruga. With me here, it is impossible for Ellen to die. Thank you. I will lose as soon as I lose Ellen. The only one that can protect her right now is you. I had decided to leave Keare here too. It's a huge loss in power for me, but it's something I'm willing to use to protect Ellen. I need to make sure that I don't lose her. Therefore, the members who now head for the Inritter Kingdom and the Demon King became me, Setsuna, Freya, Glenn, and Prince Caster. We can leave any time now, Iruga-sama. The aircraft is ready for flight. Setsuna and Freya board the aircraft. For today's flight we will need to pack as lightly as possible since we want to prioritize speed. I will apologize in advance for the ride that we will have. We would need to keep the weight of the aircraft as light as possible to achieve the fastest speed that we can. The food that we loaded are nothing luxurious and are all canned and preserved foods. Usually such an act would only cause problems when flying with royalty like Prince Castor. It's all okay. Rather, if you had prepared a luxurious ride, I would have thought that you had forgotten your country. With the current plan, we should be as efficient as possible. Prince Castor and Ellen had a meeting yesterday and they talked about an alliance between their two countries to go against the Grandsbach Empire. The ability to see and move accordingly to the situation without thinking of their own interests shows that they are not normal people. Please hurry and get on, Master. Glenn, didn't you hate flying? I'm starting to get used to it already. I also recently realized that even if I fall, I won't die. Glenn says with a grin while she sits on my shoulders in her fox form. At times like these, she is seriously adorable. Well, time to go. Destination, Inritter Kingdom. Yes. I've gotten quite good at reading maps, so we shouldn't get lost. Yes, let's go. Let's put the pedal to the metal. I'll be quite grateful if you can go at the speed where our safety can still be assured. With that, using Freya's wind, we started our journey. Part 2. It would be great if Inritter Kingdom was still in one piece. There's also one more objective on this journey. That is to confirm that the countries around the world are still safe. There are already a few countries that have been swallowed up, but it should still not be at the point of completion for world domination. But the possibility of that can still not be denied unless I see it with my own eyes. So to confirm this, I'll make sure to fly over some of the countries to check their condition. Freya's control of the aircraft is amazing. She kept us in a straight line to the destination and kept the aircraft at its fastest speed. How is it, Kiruga-sama? Freya asked. It's perfect. There's nothing I can complain about. As I said that Freya upped the speed by a bit. Healing Hero, this really is wonderful. Is there any way for this to be mass-produced? I asked. I feel like Prince Castor had mentioned something similar a while back. I too wish to mass produce it, but I can't find the materials for it, and even if I could, I would only be able to move it with the help of a strong mage. In all honesty, it takes a lot of skills to fly this aircraft. So even if we mass produce this aircraft, there won't be enough people coming to fly them. That's true for now. But I think that if we can slowly lower the requirements for material and skill to make and ride this aircraft, the wars in the future will change drastically. Prince Castor suggested. That's true. That kind of future might exist. But to make sure we can get that kind of future, we first need to deal with Brett. You're right. Our current worry should be if the humans will live in the future or will they be utterly wiped out. I've also always wondered what kind of world Brett aims for. The kind of world Brett aims to make. According to him, he wants to surround the world with his boys. He wants a paradise where he can stay with all his boys for eternity and love them. He wishes for that kind of paradise. In that case, we should also consider the option of surrendering. No? It's an extreme argument, but I think that it won't be too bad. We allow him to choose some boys and sacrifice a few every year. By doing that, we can save our country. Prince Castor said. So it's like giving a sacrifice to an evil god to appease them. Yes, just like that. That man cannot even be considered human anymore. Now that he mentions it, it really is like that. If such negotiations can be done, it will probably only cost 10 or 20 people per year per country. It can be said that the cost performance is very good. Sadly, the act of negotiating with that man is too risky. There is a high chance of being turned into one of those black monsters. I sighed. That's also true. But I'll make sure to keep this in mind because we need to think of all the possible plans of action that we can think of. Prince Castor said, his voice laced with dejection. As I thought, this man is really sharp and has a flexible mind. In this case, it might be best to tell him about our current strategy to see what he thinks. Ellen also thought of that plan before, Brett is too obsessed with me, so by surrendering myself and some boys we could buy some time for our countries and find a way to fight back. I said, filling him in on the plan. As I thought, Ellen too thought of such a plan. Prince Caster replied, in the end, it would just be an act and I could only hope that Brett would trust me as his toy and that he wouldn't attack our kingdoms. I would then need to find the best time to kill him. I continued, Prince Caster suddenly starts laughing, they trust you quite a lot, don't they? This plan wouldn't only put you in danger, as soon as you fail to kill Brett, the country of Dyrul will fall from Brett's retaliation. Are you really okay telling me this plan? I could use this information as a bargaining chip with them to keep my Enrita kingdom safe. Prince Caster said, I trust you because you are an ally, and if I didn't tell you the plan and Enrita kingdom chose to make a move, it would ruin the plan, so in the end it was better that I told you. I answered. That's reasonable. I'll promise you this, we won't move in a way that would mess up your plan. He replied with determination. I chose to believe those words, but really, I could only believe in those words. The clouds in front of us opened up and Prince Caster prepared to set out. Ha ha ha, to think that I would get home so soon. This is a good time. Everyone please look down, that right there is my country, the beautiful Enrita Kingdom. Beneath us was the capital of the Enrita Kingdom, the city of Enrita, the city of water and one of the most beautiful artistic cities in the world. This beautiful scene was spread right before my eyes. The city was clean to the point that it was almost unnatural. It was indeed a beautiful sight. Wow, so pretty. There's a rainbow. So this is the city of water. There's water everywhere. Everyone gasped. The water came from the center of the city and it rushed all the way down to the streets and washed away all of the dirt and grime. A system of both science and magic was used to clean the city. By doing this once a week, the city was able to stay clean. The trash is separated and the water purified. As soon as it is purified, the water goes to the lake that is full of fish. I am really proud of my country. I'm quite glad that the hands of darkness has yet to reach this part of my country. Prince Caster gleams. That's true. It's almost dark now, so we should land. Flying at night is too dangerous, I say. Then please let yourselves relax at my place. I want to thank you guys for saving my life. Prince Caster offers. That could just be an excuse. His real aim is actually to propose a plan that is still on the same line while manipulating us to give him the best outcome. Okay, I'll let you treat us, I reply. I knew all this but I still agreed. Perhaps this guy might come up with a plan that even Ellen and I couldn't imagine. I had that expectation. Chapter 3, The Healer Enjoys the City of Art and Water. We arrived in the City of Art and Water, Enrita. Everything appears to be in harmony here. Enrita Kingdom is truly a place with a beautiful and matured culture. In terms of history, Dyrul Kingdom can't even be compared to Enrita. The cleaning system that Enrita uses can also be used against enemies that might appear in their city. Compared to here, Dyrul Kingdom is mal prepared for war. Within the boundaries of Enrita, the water storage capacity is huge, water purification system is the best, strong barriers and food productivity. With these systems in place, Enrita is one of the most fortified cities that can last in a defensive or endurance war. I also hear that the soldiers in the city are elites. This city is a city that can be considered almost impossible to run over. But sadly, in front of those black monsters, all of these defensive features will be useless. Most of the defensive equipment will be turned useless as soon as the black power starts to rampage inside of the inhabitants of the city. Next, if Freya starts to attack the city from the aircraft that we are on, Dyrul Kingdom can take over this city. Earlier, Prince Caster had stated that he wanted to mass produce these aircrafts and not choose people. By the time Prince Caster can mass produce, there is a high chance that most of these defense mechanisms will be useless. Where should I land? Freya asked Prince Caster to see if he had somewhere he wanted them to land. In the castle garden. You can see it from here. Oh, I can see it, but it is such a beautiful lawn. Go for it. That's the fastest and safest place. Understood. Freya shifts the aircraft into a landing position. It's quite daring to land in the castle garden. I can't wait for Prince Caster to treat us. As soon as we land, the castle guards rush out into the garden. Prince Caster leaves the plane first, and as soon as the soldiers see his face, they lower their guard. It appears that the guards trust their prince greatly. I'm home. We met some trouble on our journey, so I came back earlier than planned. Welcome back, Prince Caster. I am quite surprised that you came back riding this steel bird. May I know who those behind you are, and where your Umsama and Fans Sama are? They were killed in Grandzbach Empire. I was saved by the people behind me, and they were the ones who brought me home safely. All the people around us felt shocked at this news. The people that we had left behind had asked us to save Prince Caster and Prince Caster only. His subordinates were all excellent people. They were determined to die on the spot to allow Prince Caster. The reason that I came back so early and that these people from the Dairal Kingdom are both the same. My guests from the Dairal Kingdom, please go take a rest in one of our rooms. I have so discussing to do with my people. Okay. I'll see you later. They're going to be talking about what happened before and on what they can share with us later when we hold a discussion. It's better to think positively. This might turn into a plus for us. The abundance of water means that you can also use a bathtub. Clean off all of our sweat and dirt, and change into clothes prepared by the other side. Oh, this feels nice. It's probably silk. Silk is a super luxury item, and it is even harder to get than some other rare items. It's mostly used only to appease special guests. I went to my room to rest, and soon after, a servant knocked on the door and reported that dinner was ready. We walked for a while, and Glenn and Setsuna, who have a good sense of smell, perk up their nose. It smells like a feast over there. It smells so good. This will be good. The current Dairal Kingdom has no money, so we couldn't eat anything luxurious. Our past glory has disappeared, and the Dairal Kingdom is left in its worst state. The sole salvation is that all the nobles who were greedy pigs were cleaned out of the kingdom. This achievement can be considered as the only good thing that the king of Dairal had done. The servant led us to a room with an elegant landscape of an indoor pond filled with colorful fish and brightly lit ceiling. This kind of brightness that can be achieved even when the sun is already down should be created through magic. This is quite the nice room. I prepared the best home to show the Enrita Kingdom's hospitality. I hope the healing hero is satisfied. Of course, Glenn and Setsuna were next to me, looking into the pond and watching the fish with a childlike fascination. Even if it seems like they are older because of all the bloody situations that they have been through, they are still kids. Setsuna has yet to reach her mid-teens, and Glenn was only born recently. If they had been brought up normally, they should still be at the age of playing around and having fun. I've been using them too much to my convenience. After this is all over, I want to be able to show them more beautiful and fun things aside from sex. But to be able to do that, we will need to work even harder than we are now. Kirubanisama, having water flowing through a garden is such a good idea. I wish to introduce it to Dairal Kingdom too. It's going to cost a lot of money, and we also don't have the technology required to make this. Glass is a really expensive material, and the craftsmanship required to create a dome ceiling made out of glass like this is impossible for us. This kind of room can also be used to show off a country's wealth and technology. Glasswork is a specialty of the Enrita Kingdom. Now, please sit. Let us eat while talking about our next move. Prince Caster claps his hands together. The chef behind him suddenly reaches down into the pond and cuts it on the spot. Eating fish raw is the best way to eat it, but if you want to, we can get it lightly grilled. Which will you like? I'm good with raw. Part 2. It looks delicious raw. I'll have it lightly grilled, please. Everyone but Freya chose to eat it raw. There is no such culture of eating raw fish in the Dairal Kingdom. I understand the want to avoid it. Freya's fish was lightly grilled in front of us with a bit of butter spread on it. The rest was served on a plate. The fish fillet is decorated in the original place, and it is as if the fish is still alive. I guess it's okay to be entertained every now again, even if it's just an act. The food looked great. We were poured a glass of wine when we sat down. The wine gave off a vintage scent, and it is probably something that even the rich have a hard time getting a glass full of. Now, I give a toast to the future prosperity of the Enrita Kingdom and the Dairal Kingdom. Cheers. We raised our cups and took a sip after the toast. Good wine doesn't just get determined by the taste. It is also determined by the feeling that one gets from drinking the wine. I feel ecstatic from just putting it into my mouth. It goes well with the taste of fresh sashimi. Kiruga-sama, this fish is delicious. It tastes similar to the salmon caught near the Ice Wolf Village, but even better. Glenn wants another one. Just one was not enough. Setsuna and Glenn finish their fish at record-breaking speeds. Prince Caster just laughs it off and makes the chef prepare seconds straight away. Eating it raw is kinda scary, but it looks delicious. Do you want a bite? I guarantee that you won't get sick. The freshness is without question, and since these fish have been cultivated with the purpose of being food, there is almost 0% chance of them having a sickness. Then just a bite. I don't really like fish, but eating it raw doesn't taste that bad. Although it tastes good, I don't recommend eating any freshwater fish raw anywhere but here. Aside from saltwater fish, it is usually advised to not eat fish raw. With all the bugs and parasites that can be found in fresh water, it would not be a surprise if you got sick because you ate a parasite. I too like fish raw. This artificial pond was created just for the purpose of cultivating these fish. It appears that the rich work on a different plane as us. Haha, I think I used good money. Well, let's talk about the future now. I'll ask the healing hero. What are our conditions for victory and defeat? Victory conditions and defeat conditions. It is easy to overlook these conditions, but they are things that must be considered in detail so that one can plan for the future. Victory is the death of Brett and the eradication of black power. Defeat is that the kingdom of Dyrul and Inrita are engulfed in black monsters and the world becomes controlled by Brett. I'll ask you again. If Brett dies, will the black power really disappear? I think that's the biggest hole in your Brett assassination plan. Let's say you killed Brett. If THA black power doesn't disappear, the game is over. You would get surrounded on the spot, and a commander appears in place of Brett and gets revenge on the Dyrul Kingdom. I think this kind of future should also be considered, as expected of one who commands over his country. I too thought of this possibility, but I like to think that if you destroy the root of evil, then everything would be solved. I don't deny this possibility, but when I killed the old king of Dyrul, everything connected to him died and disappeared. And if this doesn't happen, then we just have to adapt. That's true. It's not a situation where we have many options, but with the help of the Inrita Kingdom, I think I can offer some help. After saying that, Prince Caster starts to tell us his plan. Is that possible? I've never said anything that I can't do. With this method, I won't get in the way of your plan, and it could even help you out in the end. I'll have to rely on you. I'm sorry. The method that we speak of was to make the Inrita Kingdom become a sacrifice. I don't want to use it, but for now, I need as many factors as possible that would increase my winning chances. There is no need to apologize. It's also the battle of the Inrita Kingdom. It's natural that we too would need to sacrifice something. Forgive me. At some point in time, I started to think that this battle was ours alone to fight. It's okay as long as you understand. This battle is a battle of humanity. We, the Inrita Kingdom, must also take part in it. Later, when you go talk with the Demon King, please contact us. We too want as much information as we can get. Prince Caster waves his hand and a person carrying a birdcage walks in. A really well-trained carrier pigeon. No, I guess it's a bird-type magic beast. Unlike ordinary pigeons, they can not only come back with a homing instinct, but also learn the user's magical power and make a round trip. There is no faster and more secure means of communication. I'll leave this one to you. Two large white pigeons were carried over to us. I'll promise that I'll send you information as soon as I get any. I'm looking forward to seeing what you can come up with. I wish you good luck. With that, we shook hands. With the talk that we had with Prince Caster, we were able to get a few gains. If we continue moving forward like this, I might just be able to reach Brett. No, I have to reach him. When the night comes, I will immediately go to Eve, get help, gather information from the god bird, and increase our chances of victory. That man deserves to die just from what he did to me in my first life, and he's done so much more in my second life. I will not be satisfied until I can get the revenge that I came to get. If it's to get my revenge, I'm willing to do anything and everything. I'll use whatever I can to do it. Chapter 4. The healer reunites with the Demon King Part 1. Our aircraft flies through the skies. I was surprised by the plan that Prince Caster had thought up. Ellen had also thought up of the same plan in the past, but she had thought that it would be impossible to force Inra to do follow through with the plan because there was too high of a risk for them. But even with the sacrifice, Prince Caster himself proposed to use this plan. He proved with his words that he did not just intend to aid the Dairal Kingdom, he planned on fighting with us side by side. I now truly feel that it was the right decision to save him back then. From here on out, we will head to the Demon King and Prince Caster will spread word of the wrongdoings of the Grand Spatch Empire. It will be a race against time. Both parties will have to work their hardest to make this work. We perform our first night flight to save us as much time as possible, since it is necessary to get to our destination as fast as possible. By using the moonlight, I was able to navigate the night sky. I didn't have to worry too much, since at a high altitude, it was almost impossible to hit an obstacle. The only thing to watch out for would be tall mountains. Freya, let's switch soon. Okay, Tilda. Freya stops using her wind magic and the plane starts to drop in altitude. I immediately switch with Freya and take over the controls. Currently everyone but Freya and I were asleep. We agreed to take turns flying so that it would lessen the burden on each other. Go ahead and sleep. I'll wake you up in the morning. Flying at night should have taken a toll on you. Yeah, it was troubling that I couldn't see much. I had to leave it mostly to luck. I constantly felt like something might happen. It's not unreasonable. I'm impressed that you could fly so long in this condition and so accurately too. I did my best. I cast Recovery Heal to remove her fatigue. But even after healing, I can still feel that she feels strained and tired after such a long flight. Iruka-sama. I've always had something I wanted to ask you. What is it? If it's not a misunderstanding of mine, it seems like Iruka-sama is very impatient lately. It's true. I can't imagine how many of those black monsters are popping up every day. I want to end this as fast as possible so that no more black monsters appear. That's not what I really meant. Since all of your attention is on Bullet, I feel that as soon as you kill him, you'll be left with nothing to pursue. You'll end up as a person with no purpose. To think that I would be seen through by Freya. My revenge journey has also entered into its climax. Spell hero Freya was beaten by me and made to serve me. Sword hero Blade was completely robbed of her dignity and I killed her. The kingdom that had stolen everything from me became my very own kingdom. The only one left that I have to kill is Bullet. After I send him down to hell, my journey will come to an end. I've told my girls that I travel around to give world peace. I've told them anything about my revenge. That's why it is quite a surprise that Freya of all people figured me out. Yeah, I guess so. I have some personal business with that guy. I also have another reason for traveling aside from world peace. After this journey, everything will end. It's not like you'll disappear, right? Disappear. If it was me in the past, I might have really disappeared. After one finishes their revenge, everything becomes white and one loses every reason to continue forward. I'll promise you that I won't disappear after I finish this journey. After getting so many great girls, how can I stand to let go of them? Such words came out naturally. Once upon a time, I thought of this when I made Princess Flare into Freya, erasing memories, planting false love, loving each other with a man who looks down on herself, and finally getting hundreds of soldiers from the Dairal Kingdom. Part 2. Is that the first thing you say after such a long time? Shouldn't you say something more loving? Sorry about that. I wasn't thinking. So, how is it? I'm fine. It's quite peaceful here. Almost too peaceful. There should be many people that are planning evil deeds though. Because I cleaned this place up in advance. With Ellen's advice, all of the people who were thinking of causing trouble around here became calm and educated. Thanks to that, the Demon King's castle is peaceful. I'm still going to need to talk to the subordinates later. How's it going on your side? Did you beat Bullet? No, he ran away. No, it's more like I had no way to win from the start. It's pathetic. It's so pathetic that I want to kill myself because of it. So even Kiruga has times where he loses. I was confident that I could handle most of the situations that I would have encountered, but the power to corrupt the Demon King was brought out by the Philosopher's Stone. Moreover, this power could be shared and amplified to others. for a measly human to be able to do such a thing. If I had the Philosopher's Stone, then it's possible to do this, but I'm surprised that he would even come up with this kind of plan. Bullet's creativity, determination and his ability to gather information are all things that should be feared. I shouldn't be surprised by exceptional things. Eve, I came back here to find out the weakness of that black power. Godbird Calidorius, he might know something that can be of help to us, and to know this information can also be of an aid to Eve. The previous Demon King went mad with this power and Eve too might end up like that. It's so sudden that I can't think properly one second. Deep breaths, deep breaths. I don't know too much, but for now I'll act like I understand. You're right, I should call the God Bird, but it would be better to head outside to get more space. Yeah, don't want to break the walls. I don't want to offend that white God Bird. Eve and I head outside. So there's no effect on your life if it's just to summon it, huh? It's all good. It won't affect my lifespan too much, but it still takes a lot of my magic power away. I'm relieved. I don't want to make you sacrifice your life like that. Thanks. But if the God Bird is not the answer to our problem, the black power, what would you do? That can only mean one thing. She is asking if we can win if we use her as a sacrifice. I can't do anything. No. There is something, but I will only use that if your life is in danger. Anything outside of that, then I won't use it. The next time I use it, she'll probably stop being able to live normally and will die soon after. As the recovery hero, I know her body better than she herself does. I see. I know that it's dangerous, but if you think of me like that, then I don't mind using it to help you. I don't want that to happen. That's why I want to use it. That's the type of person you are, and I want to pay you back somehow. I'm speechless. I can feel that Eve really loves me. I'll make sure that I don't have to use it. Okay, I'll call the God Bird now. As Eve closes her eyes, the magic energy levels around us start to rise. An elaborate magic circle drawn with mysterious characters appears at our feet. A rip appears in the space above us and the God Bird sticks his head out. A sacred bird sang in legends from millenniums past. The God Bird should know things about our problems. As I pray that this is true, I oversee the summoning process of the God Bird. Chapter 5. The Healer Receives from the God Bird. Part 1. In response to Eve's call, God Bird Calidorius is summoned. The grass sways in the blowing wind. A decorative feather reminiscent of a gold crown, a sacred and inviolable feather. It's so beautiful that it seems like something otherworldly. This is the first time that the Lord has called me so often. Hum. It seems that she has gained the power to call me without using life. It's not interesting to lose the Lord after a long time. It seems that the God Bird knew that its power as a Demon King was rising. It wasn't obvious if it wanted to kill Eve or praise Eve. It's not like I am going to fall down just by calling you. It's been a long time, Calidrius. And what is it? The scent that clings to the guard of the Lord. Even though the gate of the Lord has not yet opened, it means that somebody has opened the gate with the law below. Unintentionally the cheeks loosen. It was a bet if God Bird Calidorius knew about the black power, but there is no doubt that he knew this. And I got some info just now. It appears that Eve is slowly getting affected by the black power. The information squeezed from the predecessor Demon King was just to guess, but now it's undeniable the truth because of the words of the God Bird. God Bird, it's nice that the story is quick and helpful. As soon as I said that, a fox wiggled out of my shirt and popped its head out. Even when I said that I wanted to talk alone with the God Bird, Glenn said that she would be helpful if she came along. Calidorius Sama, you can't say that. You'll go against too many rules. Do you want to get in the way even though it is an opportunity to get information? I brought it because it said it was useful. I thought that it had finally gotten closer to me, but apparently I was wrong. It appears he needs some punishment. I feel some dark energy. What? Wait, stop. I'm suffocating. Glenn, why are you getting in my way? I don't mean to. It's just that us god beasts have things that we can't say and do. The child fox rampages. It's too desperate, and it's not the usual mischief. Then he runs away and takes a distance and hides in the shadow of the tree. It seems that it was quite wary. The God Bird looked at us with interest. It seems that the egg from that time has grown into such a decent child. Thankfully, an evil spirit wasn't born. There are a lot of things mixed up, but I was born with my emotions and magic. So, is that so? I would like to thank Glenn for being born like this. It's a cute guy and I like it right now. Mew. Glenn is a cute and honest fox. It's just decent or out of touch. This hag. But, personality seems to have a problem. Hag, hag. Hey, foo-fa-foo. I have lived for many years but this is the first time I have been told that. I'll eat you, you little shit. Ha ha. I'm just kidding. Just foxing around, yeah. Please forgive me. Hiding his head and shaking his tail. Glenn, what does this guy want to do? I'm sorry. I was upset. What the fox said was correct in a way. Because of its role, we god and beast know too much about this world, until the Lord should not know. That's why you are bound by the rules of the world. That means you can't talk to us. There are things we can and can't talk about. To know but not be able to talk about it. It's so frustrating for me because it's like there's a big juicy steak in front of me that I am not even allowed to approach. I'm not going to cover up, so I'll ask you straight. What we want to know is the true power of black power that makes people immortal. No, monsters. I can't answer. It's information that you should not know. Yes. Then I don't need to know what it is. I want to know how to kill it. And I want to know how to kill it without borrowing the power of Glenn's god beast. If I'm not allowed to know everything then I should narrow down the subject. I don't understand the rules too much but I'm sure there's a loophole somewhere and I need to utilize that. Ha ha ha. It seems that you're quite the sharp one. Indeed this I can tell you. To kill them. You just need to keep killing. I've already tried that. Be it ripping them to pieces or turning them to ash. They just keep coming back. No, keep killing. Not just killing. There is a price for what you call black power. It is gaining power in exchange for the soul. The soul is eaten every time it revives, and eventually the soul is eaten up. Until then, keep killing. So it was a blind spot to die. Just killing twice or thrice. I was determined that it was invulnerable. If it's said like that it becomes obvious. Everything that uses fuel has a limit. I don't know how many times I will have to kill it but now that I know it can be killed there is hope. It's not just for us, it will be information that should be taught to all countries. For the soldiers, it was only despair to challenge the invulnerable army. However, information that it can be killed if you continue killing would be hope. Thank you, but I wish I had a way to kill it more easily. It is troublesome to know that you have to kill dozens of times. There is that too. I give my soul to the other side and get the price. Then close the gate on the other side. Can it be done by humans? It seems that you or Glenn can do it. Then it doesn't make sense. There are hundreds or thousands of monsters that are tainted by black power. Yes, that power is on the other side, and it is unnatural to be here. Don't admit something that is impossible. If you engrave a stamp with that intent, that's all. Can you tell me the stamp? Either to kill them dozens of times or engrave it. It goes without saying which would be easier. Part 2. It's possible. That's a lie. It's completely violating the rules. Glenn's going to do it if I could tell him that. As I thought, until now, Glenn has been destroying the sacrificial flames of black power. If you have such a method, Glenn is looking forward to using it. There is a penalty, but not so much that my existence disappears. In other words, you pay a considerable price. Why do you help humans until you sacrifice? Because humans can be destroyed in this situation. For those who are sick, humans are like fields. No crops in the contaminated field. Is it a food problem? Surprisingly, the beasts also depend on humans. Glenn was still eating my magic and emotions. Black power is the same in the sense that you can't exist without human beings. As you can see from the conversations you've made so far, both of you are outside, and in order to be in this world, I just have to eat it. I can't confirm or deny the question. That will be the answer, and you will receive a punishment that is incomparable to teaching stamps. That's right. Please tell me the engraving. Okay, God Bird sees the wall with a sharp eye. Then, a geometric pattern was carved. Is it possible to kill a black monster just by engraving that? This is good. If mass production of firewood with a stamped tip on the top is distributed to various countries, the war situation may be overturned. It's good to come here. It's harder than expected to get these weapons. When I looked at Godbird to say thanks, I felt that the figure was blurred. If you look closely at Shakugan, you will be taken away from the inside with something that can't be recovered. Is this the punishment? Godbird does not give it away. Then it would be polite to pretend not to notice. Thank you, Godbird Calidorius. If I wasted, I would give you a terrible illness. Advice: don't rely too much on this stamp. It just closes the gate. Therefore, it does not lead to something that opens the gate with its own power. Even if the gate is closed, it will be opened immediately. Now I can only kill the end. I understand. Now I can wipe them out. Hum. Is this the end of the errand? The Lord seems to be the limit soon. I'd better go home. I'm sorry, Kialuga. It seems that I couldn't afford to speak if I thought Eve wouldn't say a word. It's sweaty and my face is blue. A step before magic deficiency. Oh, that's good. Thank you, Eve. I am Kialga's lover. I'll do my best. Godbird Caradorius, thank you very much. Let's go. Lord, you will be forced to make a serious decision. So I say, don't die. I was so lonely, I repeat. But I don't want to lose the Lord after a long time. I'm not going to die. Is it still from now on? How far ahead is Eve looking? I felt that Godbird smiled. Then disappear. Eve, I have the information I need. I honestly don't put this on the front line. It must be released all at the most effective timing. If you take out a small amount, you won't be devastated by taking immediate measures against Brett. It takes time to prepare. Unfortunately, I can't withdraw the strategy of giving me a sacrifice. So, get ready to hit a deadly blow while earning time. Are you going back so soon? Yeah, that's the plan anyways. And I can't follow you? Nope. I need Eve to do something for me. I would like to arrange reinforcements from the demon area. It's also important to choose carefully. Eve needs to take control here. That's right, but I'll go when I'm done here. For what? My power may be needed. It is. Eve's power is extremely strong. It could be a trump card. Above all, in the worst case, I can start over. Keeping Eve nearby is insurance. It's okay, trust me. However, I won't do that. There is so much harvest. I will make sure that this strategy proves successful. The light of hope was finally found in the complete darkness that we were in. From here, I will start a reversal. Chapter 6, Healers Choose Part 1. When I tried to get up from my bed, I noticed that my right arm had something heavy resting on it. I looked over and saw Eve resting on it. I had just reunited with my lover last night, so of course I was burning with passion. It seems like she doesn't want to let me go. I stroke her head lightly. I really don't want to use her as a pawn. Ellen's proposal was to go for Eve's heart and start over again, but this plan has a fatal drawback. Ideally, Brett should return before the Sage's Stone, that is, before the decisive battle with the Demon King. But I am not sure if he can return with a pinpoint. In my sense, the error usually comes out plus or minus 1 year. The only way to ensure that Brett returns before he has the Sage's Stone is to return at least a year and a half. I just need to be able to start over at a convenient time, but in many cases I will go back more than a year. That is, before I woke up as a healing hero, before I met my women. Ellen said that even if Eve's heart was dug out, she would go back if he tried again. But my favorite Eve is the one I have grown on my journey. If you start over, there is no guarantee that you will meet Eve again, and if you do, you do not know if you will be like Eve again. In the first place, it is impossible to start over and contact her exactly like this time. It will be like a different person from the current Eve. Not only Eve, but Freya, Setsuna, Kira, and Glenn. What I love is the girls now, and the girl she gets after reworking is still different, even if it looks the same. I can't start over. In the first world, my hands were empty and I never hesitated to throw away everything and start over. I was just glad I could start over. But now I don't want to lose too much. I don't want to restart. I get up while making sure I don't disturb Eve and kiss her cheek before leaving the bed. Thank you, Eve. A hopeless battle where Ellen said there was little chance of winning. Use the heart of Eve to start over, and forsake the winning hand and take the chance. I know that I am stupid, but not bad. I hate myself most in the world. Because he hated himself, he abandoned his name and his name, and wore the mask of Kialuga. his ideal self, but still, this decision seems to make me like myself a bit. We were ready for departure. You have achieved the purpose of coming to the Demon Kingdom. There is no time to stay long. Freya, bad, but I'll do my best again. Talk to Freya, who is wearing her spirit. On daily flights, she has been forced to do quite a bit, including night flights. It's okay, I can still do it. It's a reliable one. When I just started my journey, I couldn't sit down and walk Setsuna training at all. Demons are gathering to see them off. The crowd of the demons broke. Because Eve, the Demon King, has arrived. Keelga, you're sly, you're not silenced. It was bad. I was working hard late yesterday and wanted to let it go. It's a lie. Don't think it's always easy to deceive. There are some things you have to tell Keeluga. He breathed so hard that he came desperately to this point, demonstrating its seriousness. I've been asked by Keeluga yesterday, so I'm not going to be over this time. But once I get rid of it, I'll definitely be around. I'll fight with you. I'm happy. But why? Because Keeluga is frightened. I don't realize Keeluga is myself, but when I'm anxious or growing up, on the bed, my words become strangely blamed, and I try to bury my face in my chest right away. Right? Dot had such a habit, Setsuna whispered behind him. I didn't know. It will be studying. I have to be careful. Yesterday, the habit was getting a little bit jerky. That's why I decided to go, because I was going to fight badly. I understand. Point at it. Eve probably grew the most on this journey. I don't know what it means to be a Demon King or the weight of the things I carry. But what happens to my little girl who is only strengthened? Oh, I see. I'll use Eve's power. So you can't do anything dangerous until then. I can't promise it. I try not to lie. Because we will always repeat something like a tightrope. Keeluga no Barker. But I promise I won't die until I join Eve. It's a promise. Oh, promise. I swear to God. You don't believe in God. Did you get it? Glenn on my shoulder is barking at his ear. Your master has little respect for the gods and beasts. You should respect Glenn more. Offer meat, and increase the frequency of grooming. If you say that, you want to behave in a way that makes you want to pay respect. Remove the dried meat from the pochette because it is noisy and throw it away. That's a special kind of dried meat. With his tail fluttering, Glenn ran away like the wind. After all, it's just a fox. This guy. If you don't believe in God, I swear to Eve, my lover can't betray, then, forgive me. I smile. I don't need words anymore. Hugging Glenn with his flesh in his face, boarding an airplane and leaving. We will be busy again. It's been a month since I returned to the Jiral Kingdom. From there, he returned to the Dairal Kingdom and told Ellen about the operation of Prince Castor of the Kingdom of Inrita, as well as information obtained from the god bird. And the entrusted emblem began producing weapons that engrave the emblem entrusted by the god bird in secret. Initially, it was planned to increase production with the cooperation of each country. However, due to the high risk of information leakage, it is possible to assert that information will not be leaked. Only in the three cities of the capitals of Jiral, Ranalita, and Inrita has begun. And bullets started to move. Black monster troops have begun to attack, in turn, near the Glansbark Empire, increasing their power. In just half a month, the three countries fell. At that time, the surrender advisory from the Glansbark Empire is being cast around the world. The playful suggestion was that the Emperor Bertardrin, in the name of the Emperor, knew that all nations would kneel. There is too much to go into. When did you become Emperor? Is it sane to call yourself God? Eldrin, the God of beauty and youth over this continent. Isn't it too embarrassing to be so deceived to deceive the name of God? Originally, thanks to Prince Castor's spread of the misconduct of the Glansbark Empire and its further rooting, the anti-Glansbark Imperial Union Army was able to be formed smoothly. But the anti-Glansbark Imperial Union Army lost consecutive battles. The black monsters were too strong and invulnerable, and above all, their army was growing every day. It takes at least 3 years to raise a knight alone. 5 years if you are a wizard. But there is a monster that can finally cross each other with only 10 knights. At first, it was balanced to a certain extent, but now it is almost one-sided defeat. and the situation is getting worse day by day. I don't know how many times I thought about distributing weapons made with the wisdom given to me by birds. But, I endured. It's not the time yet. The timing of the life of Ellen in Prince Kastu is a little later. Kielga, bad news. Another country has fallen. The only thing we can fight right now is the Dyral Kingdom. But we don't hold that long. The country behind it is swallowed in an instant. Really, the Dyral Kingdom is still defending. Because they have received reinforcements in the alliance with the demons, and have the power of the strongest heroes, Iron Freya. Ellen, it looks like you've got a reply. Yes, there was acceptance of our surrender. There is no indication from the text that it was on time. The Dyral Kingdom has been holding up for 1 month. But it will be a long-term and exhausting battle at the timing of reconstruction. Even if we can compete on the battlefield, there is not enough money and food, and people's dissatisfaction is starting to explode in various places, and it is no longer possible to continue the fight anymore. This country is about to collapse. The surrender is as expected. If you surrender earlier, the wounds would have been shallow. But if he has the capacity, Brett will notice that surrender is a fake. That's why he showed his attitude of thorough fighting with the support of the demons, and survived until he barely endured the nation to be destroyed. Everything is just to keep Bullet out of control. I don't know if it's good news, but as expected, Brett is demanding the status of a healing hero. It's going to be good. That's such a strategy. Chapter 7 The Healer Hides Away Part 1. I get onto the horse carriage with Setsuna with the Grand Batch Empire as our destination. I am going as a tribute and I wasn't about to start complaining about it. After all, the one who thought up this deal was none other than myself. It's been a while since we traveled together, hasn't it? I start up a conversation with Setsuna as the carriage travels on. Of course, there are escorts and guards provided to us on this trip, but I didn't count this. We tried to bring more people, but the other side had stated not to, so we didn't. It seems like they are vigilant. Yes, there is always someone else with you, but I'll be alone with you for a while. It seems that Setsuna is in a good mood. Even though we were about to become hostages, Setsuna is the most loyal out of all the girls, and with her presences next to me, I can be slightly more reassured. The trip so far has been good. Well, I doubt anyone would stop us. The Emperor wants me, and the people of the Kingdom of Dyral also want the peace that can be achieved by offering me. Only my women have tried to stop me from being sacrificed. Well, it can't be helped. Everyone is cute. Kiruga-sama, what should Setsuna do? How can we help Kiruga-sama? Don't do anything. Give instructions when you should move. If you say strong, protect yourself so that you can move at that time. Okay. I will prepare. That's Setsuna's job. Bullet will try to brainwash Setsuna. I can prevent Setsuna from becoming a weapon, and if Setsuna betrays me when I take action, it becomes a problem. The ability of Setsuna's heart is tested to see if she can endure being brainwashed. If after being brainwashed and she still loves me, I will be sure. No. It's not just Setsuna that is tested. I am too. In an emergency, can we believe that Setsuna was not brainwashed by Bullet? I must believe in Setsuna's strength. Setsuna, it's a promise. Trust me till the end. I promise. Setsuna is Kiruga-sama's. We kiss each other. It wasn't a deep kiss involving our tongues. It was more of a kiss that was expected from a small child. A kiss to confirm the connection between us. I will believe in her. I think those words quite often lately. I'm a mess filled with doubt in these troubled times. Setsuna will do her best. So Kiruga-sama also has to work hard. Oh, I'll try my best. No matter what, I'm me. Even if I'm reborn, that won't change. I won't become Bullet's puppet, because it is impossible for my hatred to dissolve that easily. After a long journey, we arrived at the Holy Grantsbark Empire. It appears they changed the name. It's amazing that the word Grantsbark remained. It was probably because it was inconvenient to change it. Even if the word holy is attached, it will not be confusing for the surrounding countries. The carriage I'm on heads straight to the castle. I was wondering how it was going to proceed this time, but it appears / I'm going to be heading straight to the castle with no delays. I wasn't being underestimated. It was a proper evaluation of my strength. Bullet thinks that it won't even itch if I went to the castle. We pass through the castle gates and pass through the beautiful garden. The castle must play a role of showing national power depending on how much money is spent and showing cultural power depending on how sophisticated it is. If it's an emerging country, I will disregard it. But Gransbach, which is the largest nation in the continent and has the oldest history, naturally spends plenty of money on the garden and polishes it by the country's best gardener. It has been raised and finished to a level that can be called a work of art. Above all, it is vast. The boys washed every corner of my body and I felt disgusted. While changing clothes, all kinds of weapons were picked up and even clothes were discarded. We were given new clothes and I was ordered by the boys to be in the shape of Keare. I don't really like the original appearance, but I can't go against it, so I return to Keare. The field of view is low, the body is delicate, and the voice is high. Clothes prepared are like a white robe with boys around and gold embroidery. There is no underwear, and it is a metamorphosed figure called a naked robe. It's definitely Bullet's hobby. The boy proudly said that this outfit could only be worn by Bullet's favorite. The eyes of the boys looking at the white robe with gold embroidery are filled with intense jealousy. I really feel bad. If I could, I would want to throw these clothes on at these guys. The throne was taken with such a humiliating appearance. The boys opened the door and when I saw the sight inside, I almost vomited. Bullet was there, and the boys were kneeling and caring. It is not normal care. It's not sane to do something like this on the throne. Keare, you finally came. Oh, you look good. Keare looks good. It seems that a part of him suddenly became large because of the reaction to me, and the boy seems to suffer. Yes, I didn't want to go back. Well, I'm a tribute. I hope you like it. Haha, I'm afraid my eyes aren't dead in that way. I know. If I didn't do this, I couldn't even get into my pocket. I'm aiming for a one-shot reversal. Bullet stands up. He walks down from the throne and lifts my chin. Hey, Keare, I know what your plan is and yet I still invited you. Why do you think that is? It's because you're confident that you won't be killed in this situation. Hiding things would be useless, so I answered honestly. He nodded his head in satisfaction like a teacher who was satisfied with his student's answer. That's not all. I want to give you a shot. I want to see you do your best and still fail. I want to break you and make you my toy only after you despair. What a sadist. And such confidence. Laugh while you still can. I swear that I'll make you regret it. I'll make it known that he can't break me. There is an unknown secret that Bullet has overlooked. In my first life, I enjoyed the lukewarm suffering even in hell, but still did not break. Stood up and started over. I have already experienced the torture that Bullet will do in the future. Therefore, the second time, there is no way that I cannot endure. That is the only card that upsets Bullet's calculation. I'll gradually break down and look like I had yielded, and at the end of the day I will perform a reversal play. I should be able to do it. Reproduce how I broke the first time. That way, you won't be able to doubt your performance. With this unreadable card, I will cut his throat. A dark flame of revenge burns strongly in my chest. Chapter 8. It had already been about 10 days since I had come to see Bullet. To my surprise, Bullet hasn't done anything. He had just locked me up and let me live in luxury. There was no sexual assault that I was prepared for. What is Bullet thinking? The private room I was assigned was clean. The bed was of good quality, and I was comfortable. However, there are some inconveniences. I have no idea what's going on outside. I was completely cut off from the outside world. Of course, I didn't know anything about Setsuna, the hostage. I've heard that hostages will be treated with respect as long as they don't show any hostile intent, but there's no way I can believe that. It would be unnatural for Bullet, who is so obsessed with me, not to touch me. It's incredibly unsettling to have your eyes and ears covered. I want to know about Setsuna, about the people I left behind in the Kingdom of Jiril, and about Eve. I can't help but want to know. I'm sure there are ways to gather information from the outside even in this situation, but the risk of being exposed for doing so is too high for us to take any action. I don't know what Bullet is trying to do. I'm not sure that locking me in like this is going to be very effective, even though I said it would bring me to my knees. The door is opened, and the boys who follow Bullet have brought a sumptuous meal. Normally, I'd send them off in silence, but today I decided to talk to them. What's Bullet keeping me in here for? Why don't you do something about it?
I'm sorry, sir, but I have no idea what the God Emperor has in mind for you.
It's not that he's ignorant, it's just that he really doesn't seem to know. It seems useless to expect anything from these guys who are only Bullet's sex toys. I'd like to get some information. Perhaps this thirst for information is one of Bullet's tricks. The moment we lose our patience and take action, our destruction awaits us. The next few days, nothing happened. A few more days passed without incident. My impatience was getting worse by the day, and my deadline was starting to come up. If I don't come back after a while, Freya and the others might think that the mission has failed and will come to try and rescue me. Am I ready to act? While not being able to see any of Bullet's weaknesses, I have to force my assassination attempt now. With the sigil that Kamatari taught me, the odds of winning are not zero. No, I have no time, so I will have to challenge him without the definite chance of winning. It's a stupid thing. After coming here, I've learned a few things. Bullet's cronies, the sex toys, are stronger than the rest of us, and they are under a spell. They're not as strong as Bullet, but they're a formidable opponent. In addition, as you can see from their movements, they have received a certain amount of training. It should be considered that they are able to act with reason while being affected by this spell, and there is no way to win against them and Bullet together. Therefore, it is necessary to target Bullet when he is alone. The trouble is that Bullet is never alone. He spends his nights in bed playing with those masturbators. He even lets them take care of him in the toilet and bath. I didn't see this firsthand, but that's what the boys told me. It was easy to find out. They're jealous of me, and they can't stand the fact that I'm Bullet's special. So, if I use their jealousy to my advantage, they would chatter on and on about how much Bullet loved them, how they always had one of the boys by their side, how Bullet had trained them, how they had special powers. They were not aware that they were betraying Bullet. Rather, they love him and are loyal to him. But that doesn't always have a good outcome. I'll be back. I was told that today's meal would be served in the dining room, not in my room, so I left the room. The dining room had a joke of a long desk that could accommodate dozens of people, and Bullet and I were the only ones using it. The caretaker boys were lined up against the wall. "Have you gotten used to living here?" Bullet said kindly, as if he were a teacher. "Yes, I have. I'm getting used to it." This was the first time I had talked to Bullet since the day I arrived. I focused all my attention on the conversation. I try to get as much information as I can out of it. It's superimposed. I don't want my little Keare to be inconvenienced. "What do you think you're doing? Locking me up and doing nothing? What do you mean?" "I'm going to take good care of you now that you're mine. I'm going to take good care of you." Bullet smirked at me. "He is torturing me by continuing these small talks. As long as we keep having these conversations, we'll never get any information. He is mocking my impatience with this." However, Bullet doesn't answer when I lead him to a topic where I can gather information. So we concentrate on the meal. If I try to trigger him, he will lock his mind. The only thing I can do is wait for the other side to create an opportunity. I put the food in my mouth. It's still good. There is no poison in there. Meal. This is true of every meal I've had since arriving here. It's really just a form of hospitality. But I can't afford to enjoy such a good meal. "Keare, you don't seem to be concentrating on your meal. Are you really that worried about that bitch?" "I don't know. I think he means Setsuna. She can't be as hospitable as I am." Bullet doesn't care about women, so he has no mercy on them and must think of them as tools to bring me to my knees. It was good material. She was a good piece of material. Nothing could have made me feel better. It was a good piece of work. Now it's a great asset to me. I dropped my fork. I was acting upset. "Actually, that is not the case. The coat of arms given by Bullet was engraved on Setsuna, in a place that no one can ever see. Therefore, it is not affected by the spell's powers. The reason why I was pretending to be upset is to prevent people from knowing that I had the countermeasure against the spell. Originally, I had received a report that there was 1 in every 100 who were immune to the spell, and I had been researching countermeasures using such people.
The fact that they were immune to spell was not in itself unnatural. As long as he doesn't get upset, he wouldn't be able to realize that Setsuna was not affected by the spell. Do you want to cry? You must really care about that bitch. Bullet laughs. He exaggerates his laugh in order to break my heart. Ha 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 ha. Ha 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 ha. I'm happy to see you making that kind of face. That was a joke. I didn't use my powers on that bitch. Too bad. I thought you said you wouldn't touch Setsuna as long as I was quiet. I'm going to keep that promise. Besides, I was just trying to make you a better creature. Well, don't worry. As long as you don't do anything funny, I won't do anything to her. But if you try something, I am going to have to. If I'm serious, I can destroy that little girl in a matter of hours. It all depends on your attitude. This guy is really good at getting on my nerves. I restrained myself from getting too hot. The meal proceeded at a brisk pace. The main dish, steak, arrived. It was a huge piece of meat, cut into the shape of the continent we were on. Bullet deliberately stuck his fork into the steak. There it is, the kingdom of Jiril. Hey, Keare, I have been lying to you the whole time. What do you think the lie is? Just that you're entertaining me and taking care of me for no reason. Bullet's not the kind of guy to waste his time like that. You're right. You're right. You are good. I'll give you the right answer as a reward. I've been wary of Keare. I've been wary of Keare, who defeated the previous demon Lord Hakuo and King Jiril, and who can kill someone as powerful as me. So that's what it is. You can see what Bullet was trying to do by saying this much. It's not that Bullet didn't do anything, it's that he kept me here. By entertaining me here, he completely isolated me from the outside world. That's all I needed. You're right. I was planning to break the ceasefire treaty from the beginning. With the greatest threat at hand, I will safely and surely destroy the kingdom of Jiril, which is dear to Keare. Yes, the country where your beloved females are. In order to obtain Kiaru's heart, you have to eliminate the obstacles first. I'm not going to kill your favorite girls, though. I'll be sure to bring them here. It'll be more interesting. It's a good strategy. But will it work? Oh, you think they can fight without Keare? A bunch of meat puppets who rely on Keare and never think for themselves? I'm not sure what the point is in saying that. You'll see the results soon enough. I will neither confirm nor deny. I'm just waiting for the results. So, Freya's battle has begun. This is one of the trends that Helen had envisioned. It's a good idea to be prepared, and so you won't be beaten easily. Bullet has certainly succeeded in keeping me here. But on the other hand, Bullets is also locked in here with me. It was a battle without the two leaders of the two camps, me and Bullet. The strength of those who remain, and how much we are given to our friends, will be the test of our superiority. Bullet said that my women will come to me without thinking, just relying on me, but I don't think so. If they were just dolls, I wouldn't have regretted it and would have started over long ago. But because they are not dolls, but irreplaceable dolls, I made the decision to fight against the odds. I believe in them. I believe in my women. Now the battle will begin without me. This is where the tide will turn. Chapter 9. The Healologist believes. Bullet decided to do nothing to me. It would take him a long time to break my heart if he tried. So, I guess he'll have to wait until he breaks something important to me. If he destroys the Jiril kingdom and all my women, I'll never be sane. It's a good move. But there is one mistake. Bullet is a lapdog to my women. He thinks they're my pets, that I'm supposed to protect them, but they're not. They have their own power. That's why I trusted them. None of them are incompetent. They can act on their own initiative. They can get through a crisis without me. Bullet is about to find out how badly he underestimated them. Keare, did you enjoy your meal today? Yes. It was not bad. That's why I'm not moving. Bullet wants me to move in a hurry. So, I'm not going to do that. Trust and wait. I'm not going to move now. In the kingdom of Jiril, Ellen was busily issuing orders. This is because the Grunsbach Empire, which was supposed to be under a ceasefire, suddenly began to march. Freya-san, please go out alone. Stop them first. I'm going to ask you to use large-scale freezing magic from the sky at the points I indicate. That will buy us a few days of time. Kira-san, please accompany me just in case. There's a possibility that the other party has countermeasures against flying. Freya and Keare had already prepared for battle and were ready to leave immediately. They were able to respond so quickly because they were prepared for this very moment. The girls had grown up. Then, I'll be going. I amassed too much power, so I'll hit them with an extra large one. It's because of those people that I was separated from Kiaru. I have to make them pay for that. Freya squeezed her hand to show her motivation. Ellen, I'm concerned about their anti-aircraft measures, and I know it's better if I accompany you. But is that what you want? Ellen, your bodyguards will be gone. I'm not sure if I can protect you. If it's a battle, we can handle it on our own. But this is a war. As soon as Ellen is defeated, we'll lose. This is the weakness of the Jural Kingdom. In the past, the Jural King had run amok, and the only person who could lead and steer the country, let alone run it, was Ellen. In addition, because of the Black Monster's ability to disguise itself as a human, there is a possibility that it has already entered the Jural Castle without even knowing it, and the risk of assassination is much higher than in a war against humans. In addition, Ellen is the only one in Kiaru's friends who is not very good at fighting. She is a military strategist, not a warrior. Therefore, she can't defend herself. Of course, there are knights, but ordinary knights would not be able to protect Ellen. That's why Kuro warned him. However, Ellen was smiling. Kuro-san, please don't worry. I have Guren with me. I'll leave it to Guren. Ellen will be protected by Guren. That's what I thought. If she's really serious about protecting her, I can trust her. If she's serious, she's strong enough to beat even me. How did you manage to tame that fast-paced fox? Well, it's a matter of patiently talking to it, petting it, grooming it, and so on. I love Ellen because she gives me lots of good meat. Guren and Ellen are friends. I understand very well. Shall I give her lots of meat too? The little fox on Ellen's lap squealed cheerfully. Her breath smelled a little fishy. It was because she had just eaten the good meat that Ellen had given it. Ever since Kiaru's departure, Ellen had been successfully cajoling Guren. The power of meat is great, but it's not the only thing. She used every means at her disposal to get into Guren's head. People tend to think that the excellence of a military strategist is the ability to think of a plan, but that alone is only second rate. The ability to manipulate people in order to fully implement the plan, that is the key. As a top-notch military strategist, Eren naturally possesses this ability. It is easy for Ellen to tame a single fox cub. My clan can be of some help, though not as much as Guren. You should use them well. Yes, I am counting on you. They are the only ones who can overpower the Black Monster in a one-on-one fight. Freya and Keare, please be careful. I'm sure they've already taken countermeasures. It won't be as easy as it used to be. I know that. We have enough countermeasures in place. I've also developed a technique for fighting in the air. I think it's because my level has increased that I can do things one after another that I used to think were impossible. Ellen nodded. Ellen had guessed several possible countermeasures the enemy could take against the plane. Among them, the most likely was to invade and manipulate creatures that could fly, such as birds, with black magic. Even though it would be difficult to make a human being fly, it shouldn't be too difficult to strengthen a being that can fly from the start. Freya and Keare were heading for the airplane hangar. After seeing them off, Ellen rang the bell. Then, two black shadows appeared without a sound. The Jural Kingdom is proud of its intelligence department. Is it time, Master Ellen? The time has come. Give this letter to Prince Castor of Inrita Kingdom. A letter to use, but had hoped not to use. It was a strategy invented by Prince Castor and improved by Ellen. It's a strategy that requires more or less sacrifice. This strategy could only be used if Kiaru got the information from the Divine Bird, and if Freya's stalemate is successful. That's why this is a move that Bullet didn't anticipate. So I'm assuming the success rate of this strategy is high. Phew. This situation is not very good. I've been thinking of about 72 possible developments, and this is the seventh worst from the bottom. Isn't it a pain in the ass to think about all that? Guren doesn't know any better. It is a hassle. But with all the assumptions and preparations, you will have a better chance of winning. It's my role to manipulate the pieces that Master Kiaru has arranged for me. I can't fight, but this is the only battlefield where I can be of use to you, and I have no intention of being inferior or giving in to anyone else." A proud smile appeared on Ellen's face. She knew what she could do, what she couldn't do, and most importantly, what Keare wanted from her. She knew what she could do, what she couldn't do, and more importantly, what Keare wanted from her. "You just have to think about not getting Ellen killed."
"Yes, that's fine. You alone can give me the peace of mind that I won't be killed, and that's very impressive. It allows me to send Keare to attack and relieves my burden and tension."
"Keare is amazing. That's why she sleeps so much, to keep herself sharp." The little fox curled up and began to breathe. "Now, will Prince Caster do as I expect?" She mumbled and then began to write a letter to the Demon King, a maiden who, like her, was in love with Keare. "The invasion of these black monsters is a prelude." Ellen's thoughts were already looking ahead to the future of this battle. That's why she had to make her next move now. That was the power of Ellen that Keare believed in. Chapter 10: The Sword Saint Sends a Love Letter. The march of the black monsters has begun. The peace treaty between the Grandzbark Empire and the Jural Kingdom was broken by the Grandzbark Empire. Their arrogance came from their overwhelming power. However, the Jural Kingdom had anticipated that surprise attack. To be fair, Ellen, who was in charge of the Jural Kingdom, had anticipated it. It was because she had anticipated the situation that she had taken sufficient countermeasures to minimize the damage and played her cards right. "I'm sure Brett has already guessed that I'm anticipating his betrayal and taking countermeasures. If that's the case, why did he force me to do this?" Ellen was deep in thought. There are many unexplainable points. First of all, the way he did it was too out of character. If I were in Brett's position, I would take steps to crush the Jural Kingdom first, as it is the only one that can properly compete with the Grandzbark Empire. For example, I would suggest surrounding countries to help destroy the Jural Kingdom. In that way, the Jural Kingdom would have to deal with both the black monster and the human nation, and we would have struggled even more than we did now. However, they didn't do so. On the contrary, the Grandzbark Empire has been attacking all the human countries, which has united the human countries together, while the Grandzbark Empire's forces are scattered all over the place. It's a difficult situation. Are they simply licking our chops, or is it a strategy to make us think so? I glanced at the map. Ellen closes her eyes. At times like this, she goes back to basics, her basic thought process. Her approach as a military strategist is simple and clear. She detaches herself from all the emotional elements of her opponent's thoughts and ideas. There are times when reading the enemy's mind can bring great results. However, it is always uncertain. It is hard to read the thoughts of any person, no matter how empty their minds may be, and a person's mind can change at will depending on the environment and people around them. This is how it should work. This is what he is thinking. It's a convenient way of thinking because it's based on something you can't see, their minds. This is how many military strategists end up in ruins. That's why Ellen looks at the other person's abilities instead of their minds. She does not think about what they want to do, but only what they can do. She keeps looking at the facts. "I see, that's one way to do it. If you can do this, then you're an outstanding man, Brett. If that is the case, then this would make the situation even worse. I will not overlook this." I started thinking about countermeasures. This kind of countermeasure is useless in 9 cases out of 10. But if you overlook one, it's over. Freya-san and Kura-san. I hope they come back safely. I thought of the friends I had sent off. If Freya was defeated, we would not win at that point, and we will need to see how much damage we could reduce. As a military strategist, it is frustrating that I can't prepare a second or third plan, but I have to admit that this is the only way I can move forward. The war commences. The military strategist continued to stare at the board with cold eyes. The meat is delicious. But the more delicious the meat, the faster it disappears. It's strange. In the background, the little fox had finished eating the top quality meat that Ellen had prepared and was sucking on the bone with regret. A plane made of dragon material is flying in the sky. It was heading straight for the point that Ellen had designated. So far,
so good.
That's what Helen Chan told me. There hasn't been a single attack since we left the Jural Kingdom.
This is because I deduced that there are only a few black monsters that Brett can use that can fly.
A vessel that can accept black power requires a strong soul. The strength of the soul is proportional to the strength of creatures' intellect. Only creatures with the intelligence of a human being can receive the black power and become a monster. I'm sure that's true. Isn't that strange?
It would reduce the success rate of the bombing. We're expected to both destroy the enemy's main force with air strikes and destroy their air power. If Freyan unleashes strategic-grade magic from the sky, it will be enough to destroy an army. On the other hand, an army of black monsters can overrun us just by dropping black monsters from the sky into castles and towns protected by solid walls. Even a turtle covered with a hard shell can be devoured once the enemy has burrowed into the shell.
That's why both sides want to crush the other's air power first. When do you think Ellen will use her last trump card?
You mean Eve Chan, right? I'm sure she'll use it at the very last moment, when everything turns upside down. That would mean we're in a desperate situation.
I hope not.
You're right, that sounds tough. So much for their chatter. Here it comes. The black monster, pterodactyls, are coming. It's a little bigger than an airplane, but it's small enough to be a dragon species. They're covered in black power, and their skin and muscles are raised and grotesquely deformed. There are 16 of them. It also proves that Brett has been considering air power to be important for quite some time and has been preparing for it.
Can I leave it to you, Keare?
Yes. I'll cut it down. I can't use high-level magic while flying, but I'll cover you as best I can.
No, that won't be necessary. I'll jump down and intercept them, and you can continue bombing the target. The enemy's only air power is the dragon here.
Keare assured her because of the behavior of the dragons. Some of the demons have synesthesia, which allows them to communicate with their flock without the use of external means such as cries.
When they do this, the air they breathe changes slightly depending on whether they have a companion in the back or if the whole pack is hunting together.
Keare, who has been fighting on the front lines, can tell that they are hunting as a whole pack.
Well, I'm off.
Keare jumped out of the plane. It is a simple magic that allows the user to solidify the air. The dragons fly at subsonic speeds, but the sword saint is faster than them. It was created solely for the purpose of killing the black monster, and was entrusted to Keare.
Keare, the dragon that had its wings cut off crashed down, the wings that were supposed to regenerate, but it did not. This magic sword has an engraving on the belly of the sword that closes the gate that the black monsters draws its black power from. As a result, the slash of this sword has the power to close the gate. But that's not all. It is weak on its own. The secret to making it impossible to regenerate with a single blow is the fact that the blade is less than a few millimeters in diameter, and there are dozens of engravings on it in micron units. That's why when you cut with this magic sword, the mark is engraved on the opponent's body.
This is not something that is humanly possible, but it can be done with Keare.
Keare stepped on the sky and turned around.
I'm not going to let you go from here.
I have two powers that were entrusted to me by someone I love.
It's so I can't lose even if I die.
The absolute strongest dragon is frightened.
Keare fluttered her silver hair and stepped in the air.
Killing one dragon would make someone a hero. But there are 16 of them, and they've all been enhanced with black power.
Chapter 11. The Brave of the Jutsu Burn to the Ground. Freya proceeds with the plane while Keare is dealing with the dragons that have been affected by the black power. It's not that Freya is heartless, or that she's abandoned Keare.
Keare said she didn't need assistance. So it means she probably didn't need it.
That sword saint never underestimates or overestimates her power. The sound of the sword and the sound of the dragons became more and more distant. I feel like I'm the one in danger. I've lost my escort.
The only danger in the air is the dragon that Keare is dealing with. But that doesn't mean that there isn't a way to target the plane from the ground. You would need someone as strong as the three heroes combined to be able to shoot down the plane. But you can't deny the possibility that such a strong person is in the mix. The plane was already approaching the target point, which is above the enemy's main force. If this place is destroyed, the Jural Kingdom will lose its upper hand. In other words, if their main forces enter our borders,
Defeat is almost certain. Freya is lowering her altitude while using the magic of exploration. From the current altitude, it's impossible to aim. She lowered to the very edge and confirmed that there was a large army within her search range. She memorized the coordinates and used wind magic to ascend rapidly, anticipating an attack from above. The enemy forces sent magic and arrows at her, but they never reached her. Freya's searchable range was nearly 500 meters. It would be difficult for the enemy to reach 500 meters upward, much less hit the target. The plane climbed to its highest altitude to buy more time. What should we do now? The order was to freeze it and stop it from moving. But it's better to defeat it, right? I've been given permission to do that if I can. Let's do it. I'm sure that's what Keare would say. As soon as the plane comes to rest at its highest altitude, I start chanting. This is a power that I developed to use against the black monsters. Just as Keare had given Keare the power to kill black monsters, he had also given Freya the power to do so. Freya acquired a divinely created armor, and the divine staff Vanagund. It has two abilities. 1. It improves the power and accuracy of all attributes. Ordinary ones only enhance one attribute. For Freya, who uses all four major attributes, this is a very useful ability. Secondly, it can save a tremendous amount of magic power in it. It is very difficult to store magic power externally, but with Vanagund, it is possible. For a person who mainly uses magic, running out of magic power is a situation that must be avoided at all costs. It is very good to have a reserve, and by releasing the stored magic power at once, you can use magic beyond your limits. It's a bit of a shot in the dark, but I'll make it. It would take time to activate, but the accuracy and power would increase. The plane accelerates as it falls. This magic has a long range, but I can't just fire at the ground. I need to get down to a very dangerous altitude. In the past, Freya would have been distraught if she tried to fall at this speed, but she has become stronger. While she was chanting, she was able to maintain the balance of the plane with great control. 600 meters to the ground, Freya's eyes widened as the chanting entered its final stage. Flame of divine power, consume my power and burn up the unholy ones. 7th rank flame conjuration magic Hephaestus. At last Freya's spell was complete, and from the tip of her wand, flames shot out toward the surface of the earth, and at the same time, the plane soared. This is the first time I've ever seen such a thing, but this flame is different. Garen's flame is eating Freya's flame and enhancing it. Freya had arranged her magic so that this would happen. This is not the work of a normal human. Tuning one's own magic power to increase its affinity with the flames of a divine beast is something that no ordinary person would ever imagine. The flames that were spat out ran across the earth and formed a formation. On the surface of the earth, a formation of flames, with a radius of several hundred meters, shined. From above, I could see that it was an imprint that sealed the gate that drew out the black power. This is not just large-scale destructive magic. This is a great seal drawn with flames. The combined effect of the flames of the divine beast and the mark of the divine bird is immense. Even if they are burned up and turn into smoke, the black monsters that are restored will not be allowed to regenerate at all and will disappear without leaving even a trace of ash. Well, I managed to succeed. With this flame barrier, I'm not afraid of the black monsters anymore. Freya wiped away her sweat. I was confident that my theory was correct. I really wanted to practice this magic, but it was such a large-scale magic that it was difficult to practice in secret, especially in a situation where there might be spies in the Jural Kingdom. That's why Ellen forbade practicing it and made sure that I would use it in a real battle, in a situation where I could deal a heavy blow to the enemy. And now was the time. It's great that we were able to make the right decision here. If the main force of the Jural Kingdom is destroyed, the war situation will become more unfavorable, and if it is known that this kind of magic exists, the enemy will not attack with a large army. It's a good thing that Keare is back. That's great. Not a scratch on her. Keare was flying through the sky, heading towards us. She is trying to get rid of the dragon and join us. Freya collects Keare. You're done. Yes, it's done. The enemy army has been destroyed. How about you? Of course, we cut them all down. There are no enemy dragons left. In order for the enemy to make that mistake, Elena concealed the fact that she had received the imprint from the divine bird to seal the power of the Black Gate until now. This miscalculation created an opening for her to take advantage of. Shall we not go back to the castle and attack them?
Don't do that. I think it would be better to leave before the news gets out that we have the mark.
That's true. I'm sure you're not the only one who has a problem with this.
If it's, I'll go back as fast as I can.
I wanted to collect the dragon material to make another plane.
That's a good idea.
If one of our planes is destroyed, it will be the end of us. Having more than one would expand our strategy.
But we needed to leave as soon as possible.
The plane made a large turn and turned its course toward the kingdom of Jiril. The two of them returned with great enthusiasm.
Now, the Jiril kingdom has the advantage.
Now, Prince Caster can use that move without worry.
This is because that strategy is based on the premise that only the Jiril kingdom has an advantage in the war.
Chapter 12. The healer sends a sign. Tilda grants Spark Empire. In the castle, Tilda, a large man with dark skin and skinhead features and a medieval-looking boy are sitting around a dining table. Bullet and Keare, the canon hero and the healing hero. It had become a routine for them to have lunch together.
Bullet is taunting Keare by telling him that the Jiril kingdom and other things Keare wants to protect are in a desperate situation.
While he is eating, Bullet's men come to him in a hurry and give him an earful. The information he was given was the destruction of the main force and the air force deployed in the direction of the Jiril kingdom.
Bullet's eyebrows, which rarely twitch, tilted as he was told of the unexpected development.
Keare did not miss this detail.
"It's unusual for you to be upset," he said. He was trying to get information that he couldn't get out under normal circumstances by making him more upset.
"Upset?"
"Yes, I am upset. I thought Kiaru's women were cute little dolls who couldn't do anything without Keare.
They seem to do more than that.
Or maybe you have done a good job preparing them?
I don't like to play with dolls like you do.
My women think and act without me.
Above all, they are strong."
"I can't really say anything back under the circumstances, but it's getting interesting.
It would be boring if we were to completely annihilate you."
"If I can get rid of the kingdom of Jiril, my enemies would be gone from this world.
This is the last game. It had better be exciting in its own way."
Bullet's agitation subsided. He is still convinced that he has an absolute advantage, even if there is some resistance.
"I hope your carelessness doesn't get the better of you. You're worried about me?
I'm glad to hear that. But it's not carelessness. It is a margin of error.
Even if things go a little in your favor, it's over."
"There's no denying that. As long as there are humans, there will be an endless supply of black monsters. The black monster is what connects humans to the enemy's side, offering their souls as offerings to gain power. Hence, replacing the humans of an occupied city with monsters only increases their strength.
Each time it swallows a town or village, Bullet's strength increases.
Unless we strike at the root of the problem, we have no chance of winning. I can see that no matter how good a fight I put up, the end will eventually come."
"This is why Ellen and Prince Caster are devising a plan to cut off the root of the problem."
"That's what I enjoy. Let's see what the women of Keare can do. But remember this. The more you annoy me in this way, the more violent I will become. I wonder what kind of cute face Keare will make when his precious women are destroyed."
"That is a serious threat." The man was an ace in the intelligence department. He knows all kinds of ways to break people mentally, and he's jealous and vindictive. "That being said, can I please meet with Setsuna soon? The only chain that binds me is Setsuna. Now that Bullet has broken the peace and attacked the kingdom of Jiril, if I can't confirm that she's safe, I have no obligation to be quiet any longer. I'm serious.
I wanted to assassinate him, but I still need to know Setsuna's situation.
Bullet wants to break my heart by capturing my women and raping them in front of my eyes.
Setsuna should be safe for now."
"Keare, you don't seem to understand your position."
"No, I know what I'm talking about.
Don't think you can disable me without killing me. I'll kill you right here.
Even if I can't kill you, I will take you down with me.
Plus, I know you want me.
You wouldn't kill me. I'm half gambling. The stakes are me. No brainwashing or drugs will work on me.
That's why Bullet is trying to break my heart, burn down my precious places, and kill my women right in front of me, but it hasn't been done yet. The stakes are high because I'm not bullets. Ha ha, I'm liking you more and more. All right, I'll take you to meet your favorite, but first, let's eat. I've made a great meal for you, Keare. It would be a shame to leave it behind. Bullet smiled, then sipped his soup. It's been a while since I've seen Setsuna. I hope she's okay. After lunch, we were taken to another building where Setsuna was. The guide was Bullet and his boys. After all, the boys under his command were different from mere humans or those affected by black power. There is no doubt that they have strength beyond the norm. The boys are watching me to make sure that I don't escape with Setsuna, just in case. The annex is not the glamorous one I'm used to. It's a picture of simplicity and sturdiness. There are no furnishings, not even wallpaper, just bare rock. I went down to the basement. Setsuna's room is on the third basement floor. I peeked into another room on that floor and frowned. A stone and iron cage with a small window. In the corner of the room is a pumping toilet. This is a prison for criminals. I hope you'll treat me with a little more respect. Don't say that. I'm trying my best to suppress my jealousy, and I'm making sure she has at least enough to live on. Thanks for that. It's time for you to go to your room. I wanted to look through the peephole to find Setsuna, but I couldn't find her. No, she was there. She was hanging from a beam on the ceiling, doing pull-ups. It's an incredibly hard thing to do, hanging down with only the strength of your right hand. I was worried that she might be getting thin, but she looks like she's gained some muscle. I was relieved. The food seemed to be nutritious and plentiful, if not in quality and taste. When I knocked on the door, Setsuna looked at me and came running over. I'll allow you 30 seconds of conversation. So far, I haven't touched any of the hostages, but if you do anything strange, you will be penalized. Not to Keare, but to the girl. Bullet doesn't lie like this, and he's not stupid enough to mess with the hostages. It's true that he hasn't touched them before, and if he said he was going to penalize them, he would do so without mercy. I smiled at Setsuna. How are you, Setsuna? Fine. I'm fine, except a little bored. Good. I was worried about you. I'm glad. I'm glad Lord Keare is thinking of you. You're my precious girl. I want to make love with you again, Setsuna. I want to be loved by you too, Lord Keare. I want you to love me. Setsuna is looking at me with moist eyes. As I was thinking about this, Bullet pulled me by the shoulders. He was trying to look calm, but there was a look of annoyance on his face. Keare, it's been 30 seconds. You can't go any further. I'm not going to be able to hold myself back. I'm sure you'll be able to understand that I'm not the only one who is jealous. He looks like he's about to crush Setsuna. Thank you for letting me meet Setsuna. It's for my Keare, of all things. But don't think I'm going to allow you to be so selfish again and again. I know, and you don't have to. The real purpose was to give instructions to Setsuna. Bullet is intelligent, and if you use normal signs and ciphers, he can easily see through them. Even if he didn't see through the signs and ciphers, Setsuna would still suffer horribly if he suspected that she had passed on something. That's why I gave her special instructions. When I came to see Setsuna, I was able to give her instructions based on the type of conversation we had. For example, I use codes such as, do you want to see Freya and the others? I want to go back to the Jiral Kingdom. When all is said and done, let's go see all the Ice Wolf people. Depending on the content of the message, such as wanting to make love, the action Setsuna would take and the timing of her move would change. This is also a sign, a cipher. But there's a reason Bullet can't read it. This is because that's what Setsuna and I really wanted to do. The same goes for all of the dialogue patterns I've prepared in advance. Earlier, I really did want to have sex with Setsuna, and she was saying that she loved me from the bottom of her heart, and she was a little wet. If I wasn't acting, the discomfort would be non-existent, and she wouldn't even know I was giving her a sign. The only weakness Bullet has is that he thinks he can control other people's minds. It's true that if you're as skilled as he is at using brainwashing and drugs, you can make people do what you want, but there is something deep inside the mind that you can never touch. Now, I've given Setsuna my instructions. Soon, Prince Karstu and Ellen's plan will begin, and there will be a huge fireworks display. That's when I'll have to make my move. It's time for me to turn the tables. Chapter 13: The Water Prince leads. The war continues. As the Jural Kingdom gained the upper hand, the pressure weakened in other countries as well. That's why there are steps that can be taken. Prince Caster nodded after confirming the report he had heard from the intelligence service. Although the healing hero has given him the card to defeat the black monsters, if he fails to use it, it will be pointless. And if Prince Caster were to be captured, the war will come to a stalemate. That's why Prince Caster hasn't used that card yet. Ellen, she's good. We have the same view. I unfolded the map. The map showed the gradual lowering of the battle lines. In the battles of the past few days, Inrita's army had repeatedly used the strategy of buying time, letting the citizens escape, and then retreating. As long as they couldn't win, they had no choice but to do so. We have lost many things along the way. The only ones who could escape were those who could walk to the evacuation point on their own feet, and those who could not could only be left behind. For this, Prince Caster feels pain and helplessness, but he has no regrets. He is proud of the fact that he chose the best possible move. Prince Caster believes that there are two important qualities of a king. 1. The ability to know what you can do and what you cannot do. If you try to do what you can't do, you won't gain anything and you will only cause more damage. In this case, if he had not lowered the front line to protect all the people and fought a thorough war, he would have lost even those he could have protected. We lost a lot of people and soldiers, but we were able to evacuate most of them to the royal capital and maintain the army. We were able to leave so much behind because our grasp of the current situation was correct. 2. The charisma to carry out his own will. People are vulnerable to pain. No matter how much the leader accepts sacrifices and devises ways to minimize the damage, there will always be someone who rejects it. I have been blessed with men and people. Prince Caster's plan was about to unfold. It was a ruthless strategy, but it was being carried out. Of course, this does not mean that no one has protested. It was just that many of the officers had organized and loyally stopped some of the opposition. They believed in Prince Caster and followed him. And that is why they are here today. A messenger came running into his room. Prince Caster, the outer wall has been breached and the monsters are pouring into the capital. At last, the city of water will fall. Well, then, let us proceed as planned. Ha, yes, sir. I trust all the people have taken refuge in the castle? Without a doubt. Well then, let's show these monsters that Inrita, the city of water and art, is more than just a beautiful city. There is one forbidden trick in Inrita. The plan to use it had been in Prince Caster's mind for months. Everything was as expected. The preparations were sufficient. The only thing left to do is to execute it. I'll be there. The black monsters were rushing through the four gates of Inrita. The soldiers and knights gradually retreated, buying time as they did in other cities, towards the center of the city. Eventually, the soldiers fled to the castle. Inrita has a double wall structure, the outer wall protecting the city and the wall protecting the castle. In addition to the castle walls, which were thicker than the outer walls of the city, the soldiers were defending themselves to their deaths, and it was taking the black monsters a long time to conquer. 2 or 3 days passed, but the castle did not fall. More and more black monsters were gathering reinforcements, and now the royal capital had become a demon city where black monsters hung out. It's a miracle that the castle hasn't fallen yet, and everyone thinks it's only a matter of time before it does. The Inrita Kingdom's army is tired and in need of food, and the castle is hampered by the people it has evacuated. They can't stay in the castle that long. Just take your time and wait for the black monsters. Then, on the fourth day, something strange happened. The earth shook throughout the city. Those who live in this city will realize that it is a water purification system to cleanse the city. Water flowed through the streets, washing away trash and dust. After it is purified, it flows into the lake and nourishes it, enriching it. This city was designed to operate this system efficiently. This time, however, the tremor was too great. Many people fell to their knees, and the city walls, which had been so solid, cracked. And then it came, with a roar that swallowed up the earth. It was a large discharge of water, Like a tsunami, the water that swept away everything washed away not only garbage but even the black monsters. Because it was perfectly designed, the water flowed without an obstacle, pushing all the black monsters into one place. Amazing. A woman who was looking out from inside the castle said in an amused tone.
This is a forbidden move. It would take all the mages in the army at least a day to put in the magic, and the load would be so great that the power would be useless in one shot. On top of that, it would cause serious damage to the city.
Even so, it is a great advantage to be able to push away all foreign enemies that enter the city. The monsters in the city are being swept away to a huge septic tank. It is a facility used to scrape off large pieces of trash before dumping the water into the lake. It was so huge and long. It was too big, too long, even considering the fact that it was the destination for the water that flowed through the city. The only reason for this was that it was designed for this kind of operation, not just a water purification system. The septic tank has multiple iron grates to remove debris, but there were countless spears lined up on the iron grates like sword mounts.
This is the first time I've ever seen such a thing in my life.
However, after a certain amount of time, the monsters that had already been pierced and became a wall of flesh, the spears could no longer pierce them. The septic tank was filled with almost all the black monsters in the city, which would have easily overflowed if not for their bizarre size. The earth shuddered again, this time from the massive movement of the army. A large army of the Enrita kingdom appeared in the septic tank. All of them were infantry, armed with large spears and shields. They lined up in an orderly fashion from one end of the wall to the other, shoulder to shoulder, shield to shield, not even allowing a single cat to pass through. Through the gaps in the shields, you can see spears that are far too long, with no thought given to their ease of use or maneuverability.
First line, charge. The soldiers responded to the voice of the officer with a shout and charged. The long spear, which seemed to have no practical use, was more than powerful enough to pierce the black monsters. The black monster's sword and claws could not reach it at all. It's too long and too awkward to handle, but that's because the shields are so close together that they rub against each other. This tactic is called phalanx. It is a tactic that has been loved since long ago and is still highly effective today. Violence by numbers and mass. The long spear pierced the black monsters. They had died out without regeneration because of the markings that closed the gates.
This is Inritter's final tactic, a tactic that he uses only when he is cornered to the point where the castle may or may not fall. He would use water to push them away, gather them in a huge septic tank, and then use the phalanx to make the most of the terrain. It's simple. That's why it's so strong. The more complex or bizarre a military strategist's plan is, the more it is likely to be appreciated. But this is a mistake. However, this is not true. The simpler the strategy, the less likely it is to cause uncertainty and the more reliable it is. Prince Caster's plan can be summed up in one sentence. Lure the enemy, push them into a place of advantage, and then round them up.
Second line, charge. The existence of the engraved spear has been discovered. The second time, the opponent would be prepared. Therefore, I will kill them right here and now. I want to carve as many wounds as possible into them.
That's why I've been holding back. The soldiers shouted with all their strength and laid waste to the place. It was as if they were releasing all their anger and tears. A few hours later, the black monsters were annihilated.
We won, we won.
Someone's voice triggered a chain reaction of joyful voices. Some cried out, some hugged each other, all drunk with victory. The kingdom of Enrita had paid too great a price. They had lost several cities, thousands of people, and the royal capital had been severely damaged. But they had won. Without the help of a hero, they would have all died. The kingdoms of Jiril and Enrita have defeated the black monsters one after another.
In this situation, I can finally make an offensive move. The girl will definitely make a move.
Finally, we can fight not a battle we can't lose, but a battle we can win. For that reason, I will do what I have to do here perfectly.
Chapter 14. Those left behind go for the healers.
A few days have passed since Freya and Keare returned to Jiril Castle, and during that time, things have been changing rapidly. The victory of the Kingdom of Jiril and the Kingdom of Enrita had given hope to humanity and boosted the morale of the nations. At the same time, the two kingdoms shared the imprint of killing the black monster with the entire world. It was a weapon that they had been secretly creating. The reason why they didn't start small was because they wanted this momentum. With the two victories, the enemy's options were shrinking. After all, two of their three separate forces had been almost completely destroyed. Moreover, since weapons that can kill the black monster are now available, they can't push as hard as before. But not yet. Even though it has been destroyed, there is still another major force left. The true horror of the black monster lies in its ability to replenish its forces. They can swallow up the villages and towns in the vicinity and turn their people into black monsters. If the Jural Kingdom and the Inrita Kingdom don't take this opportunity to work together to beat it, they will end up back at square one. That's what they'll think, normally. Therefore, they did not dare to ignore the problem in front of them. It's not an opponent that can be beaten in a straightforward manner. It's also a good gamble. She knew that if she left it alone, the enemy she was supposed to have cornered would grow in number right under her nose. At first glance, Ellen's move is a foolish one. What she should do here is not a defensive move, but an offensive move. It is true that if we leave them alone, they will replenish their forces and we will be back to square one. The victory of the Kingdom of Jural and the Kingdom of Inrita was to gain that time. Enduring battles are not my thing. Ellen closed her eyes and examined the future development she had drawn. There were many possibilities, but the choice that she needed to make is not the one that seemed to be the best move, but the one that would allow Keare and the others to win even in a losing position. No matter how good a military strategist is at thinking ahead and making plans, unexpected things will happen. That's why it's important to consider the range of the unexpected that can happen and make a choice. This is the only way. I like manipulating people, but it's hard to do anything but pray once things start moving. Ellen stood up. The goal is to get to the operation center where everyone is waiting. The last task awaits. The main people of the Jural Kingdom had gathered at the operation headquarters. There were also Freya, Kura, and Gurin among them. I'd like to thank you all for gathering here. It's a good thing that you're here. We're done defending. We're setting up. Our next target is the Grantsbark Empire. We will take out Bullet. At Helen's declaration, a murmur spread. They all thought that they would be destroying the forces sent out by the enemy. The Kingdom of Jural and the Kingdom of Inrita, the regular armies of both sides, with their imprinted equipment, march in step to Furcord, the stronghold that holds the last remaining main force of the enemy. But this is only a decoy. Proceed slowly, as long as it is not unnatural, and attract the enemy's attention. Our main objective is to send in a force that will take advantage of the night's darkness to attack the Grantsbark Empire from the sky. The word sky brought question marks to everyone's face. Well, Ellen-chan, does that mean we'll be using airplanes? If that's the case, we're limited to 5 or 6 people at most. I've been trying to recover materials from the dragons we've defeated, but in the end, I couldn't make a plane with alchemy. The only other person that can do it is Keare. It's not accurate enough. Freya-san and Kuro-san will use that one, but it's not only airplanes that can fly. Brother Keare left us a souvenir. It's called a balloon. Ellen spreads out the blueprints on the desk. A huge cloth balloon and a basket. It's the one that Master Keare said we might need. It's already been manufactured and tested in the workshop. I will bring aboard all the elites left in this country, including the family of the Sword Saint. If you're one of the strongest elites in the country, even 50 people are a great fighting force. It's like a big balloon. I can't believe these things can fly in the sky. That's why it's a surprise attack. I have my doubts, though. It seems to float in the sky, but how does it move? Is it wind magic? There are not many mages who can control such a huge object. I'm not going to let that stop me. I have a collaborator at. I'm not sure if you've heard of it or not. Our dragon is going to be towing the balance. The dragons pull the balloon made by man? That's exactly what Helen did. This way, we can take advantage of the night's darkness and attack from above, where we are not being watched. She could have used this move as soon as the war started, but she was wary of the enemy's air power. In addition, the enemy did not expect that we would have the means to attack immediately because we had engaged them so thoroughly. It's a very simple strategy. First of all, Freya-san and Kure-san will assault by plane. By doing so, they will attract the enemy's air power. Freya-san and Kure-san, please break through the air power and take control of the airspace. I understand. It's no problem. That's reassuring. Then, as soon as the two of you control the skies or create an opening, balloons carrying elite personnel will enter the skies over the Grandzbach Empire from two sides. After dropping a bomb loaded to the limit, we will take off and take bullets head. Ellen, what do you mean by two directions? Are there two balloons?
No, it took a lot of manpower to make the imprinted equipment, so making one was all we could do.
There. Other one comes from the demon realm. This blueprint also reached Eve's place, and she completed the same one over there. As with this one, the dragons are coming in a balloon, carrying the elite of the demon race. A surprise attack is only meaningful if it is a surprise from the sky, and in a joint operation with the demons, we will catch the enemy by surprise. There's one more thing I'd like to share with you. If the opponent is unfazed and stands firm, it will turn into just another bad move. In order to prevent that from happening, you need to make a surprise attack. I have one question. Are Keare and Setsuna going to be okay after all this? They are being held as hostages in that castle. If an attack begins, they will be used as shields or killed, and nothing good will come of it. They won't be safe, but I'll do it. I'm sure Brother Keare can handle it. Either way, if we don't make a move here, we will lose. I'll choose the option that is the best chance of winning rather than losing with my fingers in my mouth. I will not tolerate rebuttals. I am here because Brother Keare has asked me to follow him. My words are Brother Keare's words, she asserted in a strong, clear voice. I'm not going to take a step back. If I back down or change my mind, it will be a betrayal of the people who entrusted me with their care. Freya and Kure laugh. I understand. I'll leave everything to you, Ellen-chan. You're right. This is your domain. It's frustrating, but we're just too strong for you to handle. Keare doesn't keep incompetent people close. Ellen's fighting skills were non-existent. Even so, he continued to keep her by his side. This is because he has complete faith in Ellen's abilities as a military strategist. Guren, you should go too. It's not that I don't like it, but there's no one left to protect Ellen. She had prevented assassination several times. If this mission succeeds, we win. If it fails, it's all over. Either way, I'm no longer needed. Then it would be foolish to use our strength to protect a pawn that is no longer needed. Ellen was a genuine military strategist. She kept Guren by her side neither out of anxiety nor out of self-preservation. She only kept her by her side because it would have been the end if she had died. Now that her role is finally over, she didn't need Guren anymore. I'll listen to what you have to say. Guren thought you were just the servant who served her meat, but I'm going to elevate you a little bit. Thank you, Glenn. Can I hold you when I get back?
Well, I'll let you hold me without meat as a special service.
So don't die. Then Guren pressed her black fox nose against Helen's nose. A hint of the spirit of the divine beast flowed in. It's a little spell. I'm not going to die until I fluffed up Guren. Also, I still want you to love me, Brother Keare. Ellen smiled. That's the face of a man who has done it all. Ha! The military strategist issued the final order. At this moment, her work was done. Ellen closes her eyes and thinks of Kiaru's face. I wonder if I was able to live up to that person's expectations. Chapter 15. The night before each decisive battle. The kingdoms of Jirul and Inrishu are on the verge of a counterattack. The two kingdoms, having repelled the advance of the Black Army, use their momentum to send out troops to destroy the enemy's third force. But it was a decoy. The main target was the Grandzbach Empire. In the first place, the human side is overwhelmingly at a disadvantage in the war of attrition, and it is a short battle. In other words, it is clear to everyone that there is no way to win except by capturing the leader of the enemy army, which was Bullet the Gun Hero, and it is not wrong as a strategy. But to do that, you need to have courage. It is not common for people to abandon their immediate safety and go for the win. And the method of execution was also outside the bounds of common sense. I had the dragon pull the balloon and hit the enemy's vital points with my elite troops. The very existence of a balloon is a new weapon that is still under development and has not yet been introduced to the world. The idea of letting a dragon pull a balloon, on the other hand, was nowhere to be found. No matter how good Bullet is, he can't see this move coming. You may be able to make a surprise attack, but even so, the odds of getting ahead are slim. In any case, the current Grandzbark Empire is a demon city where almost all the people are deformed. If it were a normal country, ordinary citizens would not be counted as a fighting force, but in the case of Grandzbark, the entire population is a fighting force, and it is a force that overwhelms ordinary soldiers. If they took even a little bit too much time to kill Bullet, it would be over, and they would be swallowed up by the overwhelming difference in strength in no time. It was a difficult choice for Ellen, who had decided to go ahead with this mission. She understood that it was a gamble with little chance of winning, but if she didn't make a decision and carry it out, she wouldn't even be able to take the gamble. Now was the best time to make a better bet. It was a decision made under such circumstances. The balloon was pulled by the dragon. Most of the load capacity was taken up by the elite and their equipment. We carried the minimum amount of water and food, but increased the number of personnel as much as possible. These things would only last for a short period of time, so preparation for a long war would be useless. We are all elites here, and usually we are not as fearful or distraught as the new recruits. This time, however, they were as nervous as ever, except for one person. The meat is delicious. A little fox is biting into a piece of meat that was given to her as a gift, an appearance that is too out of place in the current atmosphere. She doesn't have the sorrowful look of someone who is going to a place of death. Although she has no intention of doing so, the cute little fox and her innocent gestures are a kind of coolant that soothes the hearts of the soldiers. One of the soldiers went to Guren. I heard that you are a divine beast. Is there any kind of spell that can help us overcome those monsters? Well, there is. I'm in a good mood and special because I ate some delicious meat. Let me borrow your sword. There you go. The weapons of all the elite here are engraved with an anti-black monster symbol. She placed her paw on the mark. When she removed her paw, the engraving began to glow red, and the light did not disappear. Oh, thank you very much. Look at this. The divine beast has blessed my sword. The man's shout caused an uproar in the area, and the crowd rushed to Glenn's side. Of course, everyone needed and wanted the strength of the divine beast. Looking at the crowd of people, Guren looked at them like they were a pain in the ass. It's too much of a hassle to channel power to the imprint of everyone present. I'm tired. I can't do this anymore. She turned his head away. No. 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 You like meat, don't you? You like meat. I'll give you some of my preserved food. I have a family back home, too. But the crowd didn't give up so easily. They begged and begged, and finally cried their eyes out. Even though Guren is a free-spirited person, it is indeed uncomfortable when they cling to her, saying that they don't want to die and want to return to their family alive. Family. When she heard that word, she couldn't help but think of Kiaru's face. For some reason, she had a refreshing smile on her face. Guren tilted her head. I don't remember ever seeing that kind of face, but she felt a little sad and wanted to cry. I can't help it. When I come back alive, you're going to offer Guren some expensive meat. I don't want the cheap, hard meat from the preserves. I'm desperate. If you can accept my terms, I will strengthen your weapons. Do so before Guren changes her mind. Finally, she broke down. Everyone in the room agreed to the terms, and Guren poured her energy into each of the weapons. At first, the divine beast was at her lowest, but as she was thanked and praised, she got better and better. It's not bad to be praised, and Master should respect Glenn more. Then, one last person. That was it for everyone. Thank you, Master Guren. What divine fur. I'm converting from a cat person to a fox person. You don't bother me. You can only touch my tail if you are special to me. A fox's tail is not cheap. As she said this, she wagged her tail, curled up, and began her customary fox sleep, using her tail as a pillow, which her cronies watched with fascination. I'm getting sleepy from using so much power, and if I don't sleep and increase my recovery power, I'll have trouble fighting in half a day. Guren wants to help Kiaru. After all, this is a deep sleep to make sure I are in perfect condition. This one act was just a coincidence and a whim for Guren. But that whim is going to upset the calculations of many things. There is an airplane leading the way in front of the balloon. It's a bit nerve-wracking to fly so slowly, isn't it? Just hang on a little longer. We're almost at the landing zone. If it was just the plane, we could have made a surprise attack that day, but it was impossible to match the balloon. The plan was to land today, take a rest, and launch the attack tomorrow. The rest will also be used to coordinate the timing with the demons. A surprise attack must be carried out as if it were a series of attacks. You have to make your next move while your opponent is staggered, because once he calms down, it's over. That's the landing site, isn't it? The intelligence officer who was ahead of us confirmed the balloon's appearance and sent a sign. Seeing this, they went into landing position, and a few seconds later, they had landed without any trouble. The two of them began to prepare the encampment with great finesse. I'm looking forward to meeting Keare again. Yes, it will be hard to live without him. Yes, it is. I'll miss him and I'll be aching. I thought you weren't the type to talk like that. This is probably your last fight. When this is over, I want to have a baby with Keare and relax. I've been longing for something like that. Besides, I think that Keare would rather have such a life than to have something more. Well, people around me say I'm ambitious, but I don't think that's what Keare is. Peace and tranquility, that's what he wants. He doesn't want that much. I'm surprised that someone other than me thinks that way about Master Keare. He has always been at the center of turmoil. Getting money, women, and everything else, and he has never hesitated to crush anyone who opposes him. The world sees him as a hero, but also as a tyrant who is driven by his desires and is generally considered to be the furthest thing from peace and tranquility. And yet, in his heart of hearts, Keare wants peace and tranquility. So they say, and they are right. That is the essence of who he is. It's not that he likes to go on a rampage, it's just that he's working to get the kind of world he wants. Aside from Keare, Freya's realization of this was probably unexpected for Keare. She should not be able to see into the inner workings of her master. It's a miracle that can only happen when a person loves another from the bottom of their heart. I want to win, and then I want to win Keare back, and then I want to make the world a place where Keare-sama can live as the real Keare-sama. The two of them finally felt a sense of friendship with each other. It's Eve's messenger. Tomorrow is the race. What's that? Who will be the first to save Keare? I can't lose. The last night of peace and quiet passed. Freya and Keare spent the day alone together. After the balloon came down, they minimized the amount of paperwork they had to do with the other side and retreated into their tent for the rest of the day. The rest of the time, we retreated into the tent, just the two of us women alone, talking about Keare. We had so much fun talking about the man we loved that we lost track of time. The next morning, the plane took off. In a few hours, I would be in the enemy's territory, with the faces of their loved ones in their minds. The girls flew on. Chapter 16: The Healers Meet Again, Part 1. At last, the battle begins. As soon as the sun set, the plane flew through the skies over to the Gransbark Empire. The Gransbark side knew of the plane's existence and had taken countermeasures. The dragons, which have turned into black monsters, attacked. If the enemy tried to attack them with dragons, Keare would cut them down and Freya would unleash a massive magic attack. Keare jumps out of the plane and steps on the wind to move through the sky. Her appearance is that of a Valkyrie. She dodged countless attacks and sliced through the claws that were swung at her, not bothering with the dragons at all. If this continues, the dragons will be annihilated before long. It was at that time, a boy with angel wings emerged from the shadow of the dragon that was slain and aimed at Keare with a spear. Although it was a surprise attack, Keare reacted immediately, twisting her neck to dodge the blow aimed at her forehead. It's a good thing you, a lowly human, were able to dodge my blow. You think you've got me figured out, but no, you haven't. Go ahead and die trying. She not only dodged the follow-up spear attack but also countered it with a strike to the neck. However, it was not a decisive blow. Kira's sword was stopped. Incredibly, the sword of the Sword Saint, which slices through iron like butter, stopped at the skin. He's not unscathed, but was only left with a measly scratch. It's interesting that there are things that I can't cut now. The boy angel confronting Keare wipes his neck and stares at his hands, which are sticky with blood. He is beautiful, but his face is distorted with rage, and his original beauty makes him even more hideous.
Wounds. Wounds on my body. Wounds on the God Emperor's property. A bright light explodes. Numerous spears were thrust out from his body like the quills of a hedgehog.
Keare moved further back, twisted her body, and swung her sword at anything that could catch her. Even so, she was unable to dodge two of them and was injured when they hit her thigh and side. The angel boy's attack was too fast, even with the momentary delay in reaction due to the tricky nature of his attack. Keare recognized the boy in front of her as a formidable foe and started to put more effort into the skirmish. It seems that I was the one who underestimated him. I'm getting hurt because I'm thinking about saving my energy. I'm sure Keare will be angry with me.
The boy with a spear attacked Keare.
I already know how fast the boy is. So, even if he is too fast for me to react, I can predict it. She dodges the countless spears and gets closer. Just before Kira's sword could reach him, more spears sprouted from the boy, but Keare had read it.
Keare now anticipates even the unexpected. She dodged some of the spears, avoided all those aimed at the vital points, and struck him with all her might.
Earlier, she was stopped by his skin, but she already knows how hard it is. Then, it'll be easy to compensate. All she has to do is put in enough power to cut the hard skin. The reason she couldn't cut it earlier is because Keare considered the dragon fight as a prelude and was conserving her strength.
The blade connected with the boy.
My precious, to please the God Emperor, my The boy angel crashed down. It was not an instantaneous death even though he was cut in half. He had an extraordinary amount of life force. However, the engraved sword inhibits the black monster's regeneration. He would eventually die. The boy angel was white, not black, but apparently that did not change.
You are strong.
Even though she had just defeated such a powerful enemy, three boy angels appeared, joining the reinforcements of the dragons. I'm kind of sick of it. I'm not sure I'm going to be able to win against three of these angels. I can't expect Freya's support either. It's not good. In this situation, they would not be able to gain control over the airspace. If the balloons continued to arrive, they would be dropped before they could reach the target point. The boy angels looked grim. Avenger Keel, you filthy bitch. We'll turn you into a pig's plaything. The three cherubims considered Keare to be their sworn enemy. Unlike the one I had just killed, they are on maximum alert and assumed a three-man formation. I can fight with all my might and still not win. The next moment, Keare bit her lip as she realized this. It's getting late. Here come the reinforcements. The Demon King appears, a beautiful girl with black wings and silver hair. She is the current Demon Lord and Kiaru's lover. She flew through the sky with nearly 100 black wing tribesmen.
Eve, what's wrong with them?
Keare exclaimed when she saw the faces of the black wing warriors she was dragging along. Some had familiar faces, but they were not supposed to be here. After all, they were all people who had once been friends at the black wing village. They should have been dead by now. I've decided to ask them for a little help. The Blackwing tribesmen that Eve has with her are dead. The skill, Summon Black Wings. Eve has the ability to materialize the souls of the dead. Come on, guys. Let's show them our power. Their power is the residue of the previous Demon King, and we have a duty to reap it with our own. I'm not sure what to do. This is a very rare light attribute magic, the Holy Light Explosion. The Demon Lord and her family members used this magic to kill the three boys. It hurts. It hurts, God Emperor.
Why?
We're supposed to be immortal. The young angels fell one by one, not knowing why. It was originally the power of the Demon King. It's meaningless against the attacks of the real Demon Lord and his family. Eve had become the Demon King, and like the previous Demon King, she had begun to be eroded by black power. And by becoming so, I understood what it was. Until now, the previous Demon Lords had been frightened by the fear of losing their identity and had turned away. But Eve was different. She takes a rational look at something that was eating away at her, considers how to deal with it, and decides to show that she could even subdue its power. Because that's what her lover had done. The more scary something was, the more thoroughly she observed it and thought about how to deal with it. Eve did the same because she liked and admired Keare. Eve's dependents were returning to the wings. It is a skill that consumes a lot of power, and even Eve, the Demon King, cannot deploy it for a long time. I'll take care of the remnants. Eve-chan and Keare-chan, over here. It's dangerous everywhere except around the plane. Freya shouts, and completed one great magic. The wind that slammed into the ground shifted horizontally, causing tremendous damage to the ground surface as well. A so-called downburst. It was as if a super large-scale tornado had hit the middle of the city, and that alone was enough to devastate the city. Now, the only things flying in the sky are the plane and even Keare in the vicinity. It's all cleaned up, isn't it? Maybe you could have managed without me coming to your rescue. No. I needed you. Those angels are strong. I'm sure they didn't mind the wind. Anyway, thanks for coming. Eve, let's help Keare together.
Yes, that's why I'm here. I've been told by the higher-ups that the Demon Lord is not supposed to go directly to him, but I'm his lover, and I want to save him with my own hands. That's why I pushed through with my selfishness. The three girls laughed, and then, in the sky where there were no more enemies, the balloons that left the Jural Kingdom and the balloons that came from the Demon Realm entered freely. The balloons crashed directly into the castle of the Gransbark Empire. Through the hole made by the impact, the elite of the Jural Kingdom, demons, and monsters avalanche into the castle. In each of their hands, they naturally had weapons for use against the black monsters. We should descend as well. Let's hope everything goes according to plan. I hope they're both okay. The three of us descend. If everything goes according to plan, they will meet up with the escaped Setsuna through the underground passage. After that, they will go to Keare.
Oh, wait. The three of them heard a cute voice. Don't forget about Guren. We can't find Master and Setsuna without her. It was a baby fox that glided in with its arms and legs spread out like a flying fox. It has a proper coat for flight. In Guren's case, human form is just one of the variations she can transform into. It's easy for her to take on the appearance of a fox monster like this one. And since Guren has a good nose, and Guren and Keare are connected, she can tell where they are hidden, making her the perfect guide.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to forget about you, Guren. She will be the first one to reach her master, to be stroked, and to be pleasured. You all have to work hard to get rid of those who are in the way for him. Then the three of them plus the fox ran off to pick up Keare. The enemy's attention is focused on where there are more of them. It would be easy to sneak in now. Chapter 17 The Healers Meet Again Part 2. Castles always have an escape route. A castle that is protected by strong walls is safe, but if it is ever brought down, the strength of the walls will be a liability and escape will be impossible. In order to get the royal family out of the castle, there are often escape routes known only to the royal family. As usual, the royal castle of the Gransbark Empire also had an escape route. Freya and her friends used it to sneak into the castle. In the case of this castle, the escape route was from the sewers. There is a reason why Freya and the others know information that only royalty can know. One of the princes of the Gransbark Empire was studying abroad in a certain country, and they captured him to get the information. When he told the prince that Bullet had killed all the royalty of Gransbark and turned the people into monsters, the prince became sad and angry, and began to cooperate. This was also Ellen's plan. After all this time, shouldn't we have broken into the castle with a balloon? If it was just to defeat the enemy, yes, but our priority is to save Setsuna and Keare-sama. That's true, Guren. Can you smell Setsuna? It smells way too bad in here. I can't catch her scent. We'll have to wait until we're at the surface to find her. A baby fox covered its nose with its fox tail. The stench was awful as they were near the sewers. It's hell for Guren, who has a good sense of smell. According to this map, if we walk a little further, we should be able to reach the pantry. Freya looked at the map that Helen had given her. If we take a route other than the correct one, we will be faced with a relentless barrage of traps. We can't afford to go the wrong way. There are four wings to the castle, and the first one we'll be heading for is the one where Setsuna is presumed to be held. The only sound is the sound of Freya's footsteps pattering down the stairs.
It's strange, there's no one on guard. It seems that Bullet knows that we know about the escape route, and there's a good chance we'll be ambushed.
I think he's busy dealing with the raids upstairs.
I hope so. In the meantime, we came to a place with a low ceiling. We pressed a point on the ceiling, and a part of the ceiling opened up, revealing a pantry. Freya used heat source search to confirm that we weren't being ambushed, and told everyone that we were safe. There are so many delicious looking things in there, sizzling. As it was only a pantry, there was a wide variety of food items, and Gurren was wagging her tail.
No, you can't. We don't have much time.
Even Gurren knows that.
It smells like Setsuna.
She's two or three floors above us.
I don't smell the master.
Well, then we'll join you there.
We don't have much time, so we'll take a shortcut.
Gurren, please point us in the direction of Setsuna.
That way.
Gurren points diagonally upward.
That's right.
So, if you shoot straight up, you'll be fine.
The chanting is complete.
Sixth rank flame heat magic red light. A magic that lies beyond the fifth level, the limit of human beings. It is a magic that releases super dense flames. It smashed through the stone ceiling, but the red flash did not diminish, reaching straight for the sky and breaking through the clouds. I've made a path.
Eve, please go get Setsuna. It's going to be a mess, but it'll be quick and easy.
Well, Gurren, let me know when you get close to Setsuna.
Eve took Gurren in her arms and flapped her wings.
What?
I kind of want to stay.
When she reached the fourth floor, Gurren cooed.
So they're on this floor. We're almost there. It's a good idea to keep your eyes peeled for any signs of trouble. In doing so, she hugged Gurren to prevent her from getting hurt. It's a race against time. And so we came to the floor where the prisons were gathered.
Eve could feel her magic power dispersing. The material of this prison had the power to diffuse magic power, so Eve could see that even she would have a hard time using magic if she went inside the prison. In order to capture those who can use magic, you need something like this, but it is a very rare material, and Gransbach is a big country which will limit the possibilities when preparing the materials. And here we are, finally encountering the guards.
A boy angel. Those favored by Bullet, with powers that surpass even the black monsters. The boy angel was using Setsuna, whose hands and feet were bound, as a shield.
Setsuna was unconscious and limp, as if something had been done to her, as expected of the god emperor.
What a wise eye. Her friends have really come to save her. I guess they knew I was coming to save Setsuna.
But it doesn't matter. I'm just going to beat that man or woman or whatever the hell he is and save Setsuna. The reason for this is that Eve, the current demon lord, is here. As a divine beast, Gurren knows about the power of boy angels. She also knows that it is powerless against the original owner, the demon king himself. Eve nodded and gathered her strength to unleash her light magic. A light speed magic attack will not allow the boy angel to react. You can't do anything about it.
We, the higher species, can create the divine spire. The oracle is already finished. As soon as you kill me, she'll be on our side.
No, you're lying.
No, I'm not. You'll see.
Eve's face flushed with despair.
I've done it. God Emperor, I've done what I was told. I've knocked his enemies to the brink of despair.
The boy angel sneered. Black power overflows from Setsuna's limp body.
And then the disfiguration begins.
If this continues, Setsuna will also become an ugly black monster.
This boy angel was waiting for Eve and the others to come and save Setsuna. Its purpose was to harass her, to make her despair by showing her the ugly monster she would become the moment she thought she could be saved. Bullet prioritized making her despair over capturing or eliminating her. He knows this. Unlike Keare, his women's hearts were fragile.
Once their hearts are shattered, they can be cooked at will.
Eve's expression twists. To Eve, Setsuna was a rival who fell in love with the same person, and also a dear friend who was the kindest to her. At first, Setsuna was only taking care of Eve under the orders of Keare, and Eve didn't feel anything more than a caretaker. However, the two of them were somehow kindred spirits. They had fallen in love with the same person, and they were similar at the core. And they somehow shared each other's single-mindedness. And before they knew it, they had become friends.
Eve shoots out a spear of light with tears in her eyes.
The boy angel's head is blown off, just as she aimed, and Setsuna is released.
However, the transformation does not stop. The boy angel's words were not a bluff. It was really after everything was over. I couldn't get to you in time.
I'm sorry, Setsuna, but I'll at least finish you off before you turn into a monster.
Goodbye, Setsuna. And then the spear of light was released. But right at the last second, whoopsie pooch, she jumped down from Eve's shoulders and flattened her paw with the power of purification on her forehead. The black power disappeared as if it were a lie, and the transformation stopped. Eve's despair disappears. She was filled with so many emotions that she didn't know what to do with their face. Then, with a flabbergasted expression, she hurriedly turned her right hand away from Setsuna, and a spear of light shot through the wall and disappeared.
It's dangerous. Are you trying to kill both Kuren and Setsuna? The little foxes protested loudly.
If you can save them, say you can save them first. I can only purify her after the angel boy is dead. I didn't want to tell him that, so that he knows my plan.
Something smelly is approaching.
Also, Setsuna smells bad and she hasn't bathed.
Oh, good. I'm going anyway.
Eve took Setsuna in her arms, and Kuren climbed on her head and flapped her wings. I'm going back the way I came. She passed through the wall she had smashed and fell through the hole Freya had made. Just before landing, she flaps her wings to kill the momentum. Seeing Eve holding Setsuna, Freya and Keare rush over to her. Before the air is filled with emotion, Geurant says to Freya, Setsuna stinks, hurry up and wash her with water magic. With a delicate air, they rejoiced with each other that Setsuna was safe, and Freya washed Setsuna while Guren rushed her.
Eve smiles bitterly and convinces herself that, at any rate, the primary goal has been achieved.
We rescued Setsuna as planned. If she believed in Kiaru's words, Setsuna should have gotten that object. And now, it's time to see Kiaru again. It's been a long time since I've seen my boyfriend. In spite of the situation, Eve couldn't help but be happy about it. Chapter 18 The Healers Meet Again Part 3 Tilda Kiaru's puff. I continue to gloat in the room where I am imprisoned. It seems to have begun. Magic flooded the room, and angry shouts echoed. There were two large tremors. A tremor of this magnitude could only mean two direct hits from the balloon ship. Apparently, they used the blueprints I left behind and completed it in the Jural Kingdom and the Demon Realm. It seems that Guren has arrived as well. She is a divine beast, and Guren and I are connected by our souls. I can sense her presence when we are close by.
Likewise, Guren can sense my presence. In other words, she can come and get to me without any problem.
I stare at my hands. There were manacles on my hands.
Not just any manacles. They have the effect of diffusing magic power and disrupting your thoughts by making noise if you try to construct a formula.
In other words, you can't formulate magic and you can't use magic. I can always break it if I want to. I'm sure that bullet doesn't think that he can keep me bound with this.
It's just a ruse to keep me in place. I've been quiet until now, but it's time to move on. The reason why I was being held like this was to buy time and to prepare for this surprise attack. The time is now ripe. I concentrated my magic power inside myself, deep into my soul. I had started working on this an hour ago. The shackles dispersed the magic power. However, it could not reach the depths of my soul. The power stored in the depths of my soul explodes at once. There was a limit to the amount of magic power that the manacles could disintegrate. In this state, I could still perform alchemy. A terrible noise stirs in my head, but it's no problem. The pattern of the noise is constant. I've tried it many times since the other day and got used to it. No matter how much I get used to it, the intense pain of having my brain ripped apart is something that would make a normal person lose his or her mind. But I'm used to the pain. The alchemy is complete, and the shackles are off. Now, let's get out of here. The first thing to do is to meet up with Freya and her team. I put my hand on the door of the room and used alchemy to open the lock. Naturally, there are guards at the door. They were Bullet's favorites, the angels. They are black monstrosities, but contrary to the others, they shine brightly. They're the best of the best among Bullet's male prostitutes. You're on your own. I was about to say something when my words were interrupted. The reason is simple. I grabbed him by the face. Revise.
The magic I unleashed deformed it into an ugly mess. This is the kind of instant death magic I'm good at. But since I'm dealing with a black monster, I'll use it differently this time. I couldn't kill the black monster, so I made it unable to move. In a way, it was more hell than death. The other boy angel lunged at me with a spear. I catch the blow with a lump of flesh just in my hand, and thrust it deeper to tease out the spear. The boy angels go pale and stiffen. Surprisingly, I thought these guys had lost their human hearts, but they seemed to have a sense of camaraderie. They were upset and saddened that their friends were hurt. That's a clear weakness. I would not be the one to miss that opportunity. I stepped in further with the flow of pushing the lump of meat and grabbed its head like the first one. Revise. Next, I played with his brain. The part that controls reason is thoroughly destroyed, reducing it to a mere animal. What happens when the part that makes us human is destroyed? That's bullets, male whore. I leave the broken boy angel behind. This is a nest of monsters. I'll be back. I went down, down, down. I encountered black monsters again and again. I used to feel like I had no choice but to flee. But now I can fight. While I was trapped here, I had been watching them with my jade eyes. What kind of creature? What kind of structure? I've spent so much time with the eyes of a spirit that sees everything. I should be able to understand most of it. What it could do and what it couldn't do. I know how to kill them. The fact that I was able to defeat the boy angels earlier without any trouble was just a result of that. However, it's getting a little tedious. I need a weapon. I shout with all the strength in my soul. Come, Georgius. I call my divine treasure. This will make me more efficient at killing. Let's get to my women. Covered in blood, I continue on my way. In my right hand is a sword engraved with the crest given to me by the divine bird. In my left hand is Georgius. The sword in my right hand is a stolen sword that I improvised and enhanced with alchemy. It's barely satisfactory, but it's good enough. You can't use the magic power recovery from loot against black monsters. Their magic power is poisonous to humans. While I'd like to conserve my magic power, they just won't let me. My cloaking skills don't work against black monsters, so I'm forced to fight them repeatedly, and the number of enemies is still increasing. When I was wondering what to do, I felt a familiar chi in the corners of my mouth lifted. The black monster that came at me from behind was cut in two. There was a beautiful female swordsman there. Keare, you didn't need me to rescue you. Not really. Keare threw a potion to me and I drank it down. I'm grateful. I've missed you, Lord Keare. With ice claws growing in both hands, Setsuna passes by and pierces the enemy in front of her, icing him from the inside out. Had Setsuna been rescued as planned? I was worried about her. It seemed that Keare and Setsuna weren't the only ones who showed up. A noisy presence was approaching. You should praise Guren. It was Guren who saved Setsuna and guided her here. The fox-eared beautiful girl's form of Guren shot a purifying fireball over my back. You can't keep all the credit to yourself, Guren. More and more enemies came. However, they too were pierced by the spears of light and dissipated. A mixture of ultra-rare light magic and the power of a demon king. There is only one person in the world who can use something like this. You should be more than happy now that your girlfriend is here. Spreading her black wings, Eve smiles at me. Keare, Setsuna, Guren, Freya, Eve. My women, they were supposed to be just tools, but before I knew it, they had become something irreplaceable. When I saw them, I was filled with love from the bottom of my heart. Thank you, everyone, for coming. I'm glad you're all doing well. My expression naturally relaxed. Everyone smiled back at me. I felt like I wanted to make love with them, despite the situation. I'm so relieved that Keare is okay, too. I was worried about you the whole time. Sincerity is not shown through words. It has to be meat. Excuse me, Keare. Is your ass alright? Some people need to be punished, but you can love and punish them later. It's time for our victory. It's not like Setsuna and I didn't do anything during the time we were captured. We've prepared a plan to win. I had discovered a serious weakness that Bullet hadn't even noticed. Bullet would be convinced that he had won even in this situation. Let's smash that mongrel, make him crawl, and shove him to the edge of despair. That's all I've been thinking about for the past few months. how to make him suffer. I couldn't wait to put it into action. Chapter 19. The healer sees through everything. I met up with Setsuna and the others. The first thing I did after meeting up with them was use Jade Eye to examine Setsuna, to see if anything had been planted in her. How about you? Is there anything wrong with Setsuna?
No, I'm fine, Keare. There was a little bit of miasma, but that's about it. There's really nothing wrong. However, I suspected that Bullet had at least one last thing in store for us. I lifted Girin's head, who had returned to fox mode, and brought her to Setsuna. She yawned hazily and breathed out the red lotus cleansing flame. The small amount of miasma that remained would disappear with it. Keare asks, have you learned anything from Bullet?
Yes, I've learned a lot. The reason I was here was to look for assassination opportunities. But that's not all. I was close to Bullet, looking for his weaknesses and to see if he could keep his wits about him while accepting the malicious power from the other side. It's crazy, to say the least. The Demon Lord is a vessel to receive the power of the other side. Then, the power of the other side gradually corrupts the being, and in the end, they go mad. All the Demon Lords could not escape that fate, and yet, Bullet is more sane than any Demon Lord before him. Even as he accepts more power, he continues to be who he is. There is definitely some kind of ploy behind this. I'm sure there's a trick to it, and if I know it, it will help me save Eve from going crazy. Bullet's cronies, the angels, they were able to maintain their personalities while applying more power than normal black monsters. The secret lies in the surgery, what they call consecration. By undergoing the said sacrament, they kept their consciousness even after becoming black monsters. And for the boy angels, consecration didn't just mean not falling into a monster. It was a source of confidence that they were different from the others. Surgery. What kind of surgery is that? I secretly searched the memories of the angels with recovery, and it seems that the black power resides in the brain and makes people crazy. But once it's removed, the black power won't build up in the brain. They thought I couldn't use magic, so it was easy to do. That's how I found out what sanctification was. A surgery to remove a part of the brain. The location is the frontal lobe. Once I recovered a surgeon, I learned that if you remove that part, your personality becomes calmer. Supposedly, black power gathers in the area that controls people's anger and depressed emotions, and it makes them crazy. So if you remove it, you can keep your sanity. Those angels say that the sanctification is something that Bullet got through divine revelation. Perhaps, just before he was invaded by the black power, he somehow realized how it worked and shot himself in the brain with his own bullet. He didn't lose himself because the black power eroded him afterwards. That's ridiculous. It was crazy to bet on that idea when there was no proof of it, and it was insane to shoot out one's own brain, even partially, with a bullet. But I know that Bullet could do such a thing with impunity.
Well, does that mean you'll have to open my head and cut out my brain?
Eve chimed in and simultaneously covering her forehead with her hand, her face slightly disturbed. She was frightened because he had said that he would try that method on Eve if he found a way to keep her sanity.
No, I won't. I have the memories of the boy angels, so I can recreate the operation, but I'll have to remove part of their brains.
We don't know what the side effects will be. And besides, if you want to prevent the black power from gathering there, you don't have to worry about removing it. You just need to infuse yourself with Guren's power periodically.
Well, that's good. That was pretty scary.
Eve is terrified.
I don't want to do that to her either. If that surgery is real, Lord Keare has a good shot at taking Bullet down. That's what I'm trying to do. Reduce a monster with intelligence and skill to a mere monster. The amount of black power hidden in his body is too overwhelming, but it's only concentrated at one point. If we drop him to a mere monster, we'll have a chance to win. It looks like we can win, so let's hurry up. The decoys are not going to last that long. There's still a lot of fighting going on, and there is even a boy angel. They haven't been wiped out yet. It's unfathomable that most of the soldiers are still alive and well, given the scale of this battle. It's thanks to Guren. Yesterday, I put the power of purification into everyone's weapons. The little fox had a smug look on her face. I can't believe that the listless Guren would do such a thing. I can't say no if they all went down on their knees crying. Besides, I'm gonna be in meat heaven when I get home.
Definitely the second half is the main reason, but the former is not irrelevant either. Maybe Guren is getting a little more interested in people. She used to be indifferent to everyone but us. But now she seems to be different.
That's a good sign. That's enough standing around for now. Let's take down Bullet as soon as possible. If the elites are fighting well, Bullet's defense is thin. In addition, before our army is destroyed, we might be able to use Recover on Bullet and turn him into a mere monster. The five of us formed a lump and plowed through the crowd of black monsters. With me and my women, we will not fall behind. We are already well prepared to deal with the monsters. I don't feel like losing. We will keep moving forward. I know exactly where Bullet is. According to Guren, that area had the most putrid smell. Guren says that the amount of miasma leaking out is so overwhelming that it's impossible to mistake his location and hide in plain sight. She said no one would be foolish enough to lose sight of the sun on a sunny, cloudless day. It's revolting. But that's how strong it is. We are almost at Bullet's throne. All of you, be careful of Bullet's attacks. His bullets have no blind spot. I advise Setsuna and the others. Bullet's weapon divine treasure is the divine gun Taslim. It shoots magic bullets with overwhelming range and speed. In addition, you can choose from bursting and tracking bullets to suit every possible situation. This is the strongest of all the heroes. This is a monster from another dimension that has gained the power of a demon king. If it's slower than light, I can still react. The Eye of the Ice Wolf is good. Setsuna will be fine. I'm confident she can withstand a few hits. I'm counting on you. It's not clear how much that magic bullet has evolved. Our strategy is simple. The other four of us will secure a path, and I will use recovery to restore his brain and turn him into a monster. We only need one chance. In the throne room, two boy angels are guarding the door. Before they can open their mouths, Eve's spear of light will pierce their heads. Keare will cut the door in two, and I will kick it open and enter the room. Now for the final battle. Bullet has committed too many atrocities. He's done a lot of harm to me, both in the past and in this world. It's time for me to settle the grudge that's embedded within me. Chapter 20. A Strategist's Melancholy. Alone in her office, Ellen was thinking about Keare and the others. I hope my assumptions are wrong, but they're probably not. It was Ellen's habit to speak her mind as it helps with organizing her thoughts. This time, the unnatural aspects of this battle were unsettling for her. Originally, this battle was at an overwhelming disadvantage. In the midst of that desperation, if there was a move that allowed me to win, I would always bet everything on it. I kept walking on the tightrope, on a very thin thread, and finally came to this point. But that shouldn't have been the case. Originally, Bullet's side had a huge advantage in this battle. If Ellen were in Bullet's position, she would take the time to make sure she crushed him. That way, she could slowly torture him to death without any hope. However, Bullet made a recklessly aggressive move. It wasn't that it was bad. I mean, if it hadn't been for me or Prince Caster, our side would have lost. However, there was only one return move that Ellen could make in this situation. By continuing to do that one brilliant move, she had been able to find a way to win in the midst of this power gap. However, Ellen doesn't think that this is a miracle or the result of Bullet's superior intelligence. If it really is a miracle, or if it really exceeded Bullet's expectations, then there would be no such thing as only one option to choose from. In other words, I'm being forced to choose that one brilliant way. I've always been aware that Bullet's goal is not to win the war or even to conquer the world. It's just a distraction. He's been trying to create this situation from the beginning. Even though she knew that, she sent Freya and the others to rescue Keare without saying a word. Keare said, "I can start over again with this life. It's a very attractive option. I'm sure that's what everyone wants. It's very likely that Bullet knows about that too. Maybe that's what he wants. His goal is to create a situation where Keare, Eve, and the women that Keare cares about are all under his control from the beginning. Then, he puts him in a situation where he has to use recovery to turn back time. If all the women he loves are killed in front of him, and Eve's heart is right in front of him,
he will turn to recovery. That's what he wants. As such, the rescue of Setsuna and Kiaru will easily be accomplished. This was what Bullet had in mind. It's a shame I can't see up close what Brother Kiaru will do when he's cornered. I want you to come back safely. If not, I won't be able to tell you what happened. It's not that I've regained my memory. It was a result of her analysis of the situation and her own abilities. Even if he could change her appearance, with Ellen's ability, once she started to suspect, she would be able to recognize that she had memories from the Jural Kingdom, a place where traces of Norn remained. Then, Ellen uses the intelligence department to thoroughly investigate Norn and collects information about herself. With her memories sealed, she has taken on the personality of Norn. Ellen's expression changed from her usual dainty smile to a somewhat evil one. I won't allow you to make me go this far and die in vain. The man who overpowered me must not be allowed to be defeated. The reason why Ellen reconstructed Norn was not for revenge against Kiaru, but because she judged that the knowledge and abilities of Ellen were not enough to deal with this situation, and because she needed the cruelty of Norn and the intuition to see the enemy's vital point. Ellen doesn't hold a grudge against Kiaru even after getting Norn back. However, there was still a place where we could play. It's the moment at the end of the game when Bullet is sure of victory. Because he has been getting his way until the very last moment, there is a small window of opportunity. It's the one brilliant move that Bullet has prepared. It was by no means a surefire move. It's uncertain and relies on the deadly power of Kiaru and Freya's team, which is too much of a gamble. It is only because of that it can work. This is the power of Princess Norn that Kiaru feared even more than the heroes. And Norn has never lost a gambling game. Well, let the games begin. And if they want to give Kiaru a second chance, they will destroy the places that are important to him. Ellen Norn laughs. We have no forces, no chance of reinforcements, and we are completely surrounded. But so what? We've planned ahead for this. Therefore, we have enough safety measures. And for Bullet, this is only a temporary ploy, not a serious one. Then I'll break it down for you. I'm not going to die until I at least see my brother Kiaru again. Let's just give it a try. And so, praying for Kiaru's safety, we started the game in Jural Castle, without any good pieces. At the same time, the final battle between Kiaru and Bullet had begun. Chapter 21. The healer smiles fearlessly. I step into Bullet's throne room, and at the center stood Bullet. My sixth sense is screaming at me that Guren's nose was nearby. I've been licked. The fact that he's here alone means that he doesn't even see this situation as a crisis. Our separate team, the elites of the Jural Kingdom and the demons, are doing a better job than I expected. They have stalled a majority of the enemy forces. Thanks to them, I was able to conserve my magic and physical strength until this point. I'll go first. Sixth rank flame heat magic red light. This is the magic that lies beyond the fifth level, which is the limit of humans. It is a spell that releases super dense flames. We've come to kill him. There is no need for us to exchange words. This is my greeting. Freya said that she used this magic to save Setsuna earlier. In that situation, she smashed through the castle from underground and broke the ceiling. A blow of that magnitude when fired at an individual will definitely kill them. Those protecting Bullet were incinerated with ease, but none of that matters. Now, a path has been created in front of me. That's enough. Everyone, lend me your strength for the future of me and my loved ones. Black wings summoning. Eve spreads her wings. Each and every feather shines brilliantly. It is the glow of the soul. They become particles of light that radiated from her and materialized to Einherjar, with black wings. The black-winged people who died, leaving behind their regrets, entrusted their thoughts and souls to Eve's wings. And Eve can wield that power. With the power of the Demon King Eve superimposed on the power of their former lives, their combined forces are comparable to that of the higher demons. The Black Wing tribes clashed with the monsters that were swarming to block the path Freya had opened, but they did not set foot onto the path leading to Bullet. We charged along that trail. You're so impatient, Kiaru. Bullet laughed, held up his gun, and pulled the trigger. Kuro accelerates in front of me. Uncle Bullet,
You've changed so much.
Kira's sword shines with magic and energy. With that sword, Kira slashes the magic bullet. The bullet at the speed of light was slashed by the sword with reflexes that equally matched its speed.
Kira proceeds to slash the incoming bullets. This is a maneuver that can only be done by combining the skills of the sword saint and her other skill. I can't do something like this. It seems like the bullets have stopped coming.
No, it didn't stop. The next shot was a shotgun shell. It's physically impossible for even a sword saint to cut off all of the shotgun shells. There's also Setsuna. The ice wrapped around Kira's body.
Setsuna was doing her best to create ice. The bullets initiated impact. However, there were no fatal wounds.
Kira was blown away by the explosion, engulfing Setsuna, who was trying to support her.
Looking at them, I continued on. All of their hard work was just to get me to him. Bullet and I face each other. My recovery will be ineffective against him, who is surrounded by a dense miasma and magical power, unless I touch him directly.
Four more steps. Thanks to Freya and the others, I've made it this far. From here on, I have to go on my own. The magic bullets are loaded into Bullet's gun. Perhaps it's because I'm concentrating so hard, but I feel like time is at a standstill. The trigger was pulled. It's impossible for me to slice down a bullet at the speed of light like Kira. I can defend myself, but I don't have time to defend myself right now. That's why I'm going to try to avoid fatalities, and even though I'm tanking them, I'm going to go further. Bullet is not going to kill me. That's why I'm not afraid of pain and injury. I can get there.
Bullet's shot hits my left shoulder and blows my arm off. Thanks to the penetrating power of the bullet, it didn't have any pushback. That's why I can continue my charge.
Blood is gushing out of the wound.
Still, I can move for a few tens of seconds.
Forward, push on forward.
One more step, a follow-up.
Bullet gouges out my side. It doesn't matter.
I take the last step. I reach out my hand.
While bleeding, with all the power of my will, I grab a bullet's bald head.
And then, I unleash the magic that was both my starting point and my ultimate goal.
Recovery. A partial loss of the frontal lobe.
He shot himself in the head, and his brain is recovered. In that instant, all of his experiences flow into me.
Normal recovery is just an enhancement of self-healing power. Therefore, it can only heal things that would have been mended on its own. For example, if you are affected by cancer cells, it will only have the opposite effect of increasing the number of cancer cells, and if your body has no antibodies, it cannot cure viral symptoms. Even if you can heal a simple fracture, complex fractures will stick in a strange way.
Lost arms, eyes, and other parts of the body will not return. As you can see, the original recovery is a useful power, but it is full of flaws. Of course, it is also impossible to do something about a missing brain, as in this case. However, the recovery of the heroes of healing is different. It is a way to wind back time, or the recreation of life. Its essence is not to heal, but to transform into the desired state. In order to do this, I read the entire experience of the other person, create the correct blueprint from it, and then reconstruct it according to the correct blueprint. Therefore, it can be a universal recovery. As a side effect, all of the opponent's experiences will flow into your brain during the process of creating the blueprint based on the opponent's information.
What is this?
What the heck? This is impossible. A scream fills my throat.
Bullet's experience is tormenting me.
My pain tolerance and fear tolerance are not functioning properly.
Why can you go through all this and still act like a person? How can you not be broken? How can you go through all this hell and still be a person?
I fall to my knees.
Somehow, I manage to catch my breath and apply recovery to myself. The flesh and organs of my missing left arm and side are restored.
What happened to Bullet?
Thank you,
Keare. Thank you for healing me. It's been a long time since I've had such a clear mind.
He was smiling. There was no sign of him turning into a black monster.
What are you surprised about?
Oh, I see. You thought fixing this place would turn me into a monster. He poked and prodded the area I had healed with his finger.
Why? No, there's no need to ask that.
I got the answer along with his memory when he recovered. I'm glad you noticed.
My lovely Keare, You are correct. I was able to avoid becoming a monster by shooting through here before I was turned into one. My favorites will not be turned into monsters by doing so with sanctification. But hey, how could I leave such an obvious weakness? In addition, he did not dare to use it against his own private army of boy angels, who were also his pet. The only reason for this was to convince me that there was no other way to maintain his sanity. And now, Keare, the fun is just beginning. Bullet laughed, and the black power swelled explosively and began to flow. The bodies of the black monsters that Freya and her friends were fighting swelled up. More horrifying, more powerful. Freya and her friends were visibly being pushed back. Oh no. This is not good. It's strong. Behind me. Keare, I'll take care of this. You concentrate on that. HMPH. I won't slow you down. No matter how optimistic I am, I'll be wiped out in a few minutes. Come on, Keare. Let's do it. Yeah, sure. The plan to drive Bullet to the brink of madness had failed. The man in front of me is stronger and more invulnerable than I am. I don't have a single card that can kill him. It is likely that the crest of the divine bird won't work on him. Escape is also impossible. He lured us here. That's why our plan worked out so well. And I have no intention of letting him go. I'm in so much trouble. I had no idea that Ellen was right about this. Now I'm going to have to gamble. Come on, let's make love. Keare, you. No thanks. Go ahead and masturbate on your own, you faggot. I smile wickedly. It's not over yet. I haven't been defeated yet. It's just the beginning. Chapter 22. The healer takes a gamble. By healing his brain, I can drive him crazy. But my plan was shattered. The bullet in front of me is stronger than me. There was no way I could beat him one-on-one. And even if I were to ask Setsuna and the others for help, my women would be overpowered by a reinforced black monster. Bullet laughed. I thought there were no openings left. But there was one weakness Bullet had. It's that he apparently doesn't want to kill me. Of course, they were aiming for my vital points with unmatched accuracy. However, they seem to be aiming in a trajectory where I can avoid a fatal wound. I can recover instantly if I don't receive a fatal wound. But my mana is limited. At some point, I'll reach my limit and won't be able to move. That's what Bullet is aiming for. Now what? To catch me without killing me. Bullet, that's a very good strategy. Ha ha ha. I'm surprised you noticed. So what are you going to do now? We don't have the cards to kill Bullet. There is only one card left that could kill him, but it is useless in this situation. Both of us can be damaged, but cannot be killed. The moment I dodge the bombardment and land on the ground, a number of black tentacles will extend from around me. I slash them away with my sword, and when I stop moving for a moment, I am targeted by Bullet's gunfire. I can't dodge, and the flesh of my arm is taken away, but Georgia's auto recovery immediately restores it. Also, my mana decreases. Eve is unaware that she is fighting an enhanced monster. TCH. Almost unconsciously, I break into the line of fire and use improve to change my status allocation and skills to specialize in defense. In addition, I use mana to create a protective barrier. It's not a matter of catching it head on, but using its shape to channel it. Even so, the difference in power output meant that it was just barely defensible. I'm sorry, Keare. I'm not looking for an apology, just defeat the monster. Bullet went for Freya this time. And with the same thing from earlier, I was able to activate the barrier again. My mana was dwindling rapidly. The situation is getting worse by the minute, and I did not have time to make a counterattack. What? This. Our formation begins to collapse. The number of enemies does not decrease. In the meantime, our side is injured and our resources are depleted. This is not like you, Keare. I'm disappointed that you have no other plan than to drive me crazy with your black power. Did you think you were gambling on a single hope? I'm sorry, but it's a little early to be so sure of victory, isn't it? Yeah, I guess so. I guess it was a little early. Bullet snaps his fingers. The floor shakes, turning into black sludge and sprouting countless tentacles. The floor itself is a black monster. No, no, Master Keare, cling to my wings. In addition, The black monsters that had been fighting Setsuna and the others earlier melted and gathered around the tentacles, as if they had been swallowed by the roots of a massive black tree. Setsuna and the others tried to resist, but they fainted. They were hit by the miasma. "Your precious women are in my hands. I can kill them with a snap of my fingers. Make your move."
"You know I won't hesitate to do so."
"I don't care if you move. A Ken might save one of them."
"If I give the signal, all four of them will be killed at the same time. If Bullet is right, there is a good chance that I can save one of them, but the other three are certain to die."
"Setsuna, Freya, Keare, and Eve.
All of them will die, the women I love."
"I'm not sure if you're confused, but I can see the anxiety and bitterness on your face.
I feel sorry for you, Keare.
The only reason you're not doing so right now is because you want to negotiate."
"What the hell do you want me to do?"
"You're a smart guy, Keare."
"That's right, negotiate."
Bullet waved his arm and caught Eve, who fainted, and the big tree carried her to Bullet.
"Keare, you are acting very unnaturally.
You know too much about things that you, a mere villager, should not know, and you have acquired too many skills that a mere villager cannot acquire. There were many times when you acted as if you could see the future."
Bullet's greedy gaze pierced through me. "I've been thinking about it for a long time, researching it, and I've come up with an answer."
"Keare, you can rewind time with recovery. I was convinced, though, when I saw the way you looked at me in our first encounter."
"Keare, you were my favorite, and I wanted to make love to you, but I hadn't done anything yet. Yet, your hatred was stronger than anyone I've ever met. It was then that I realized that I loved you in a way that I never knew I could."
"If you were a villager who did not know anything, you would have been turned into a puppet by Princess Flair, become a useless elixir, and set out on a journey with me, Blade, and Princess Flair to defeat the Demon King. Considering our personalities, it's easy to see how you'd be adored."
"That's exactly the path I took the first time round,"
Bullet continued.
"In the midst of this journey, something brought you back in time.
And so, you were taking revenge on us who had taken your life, trampled on it, and played with it. Isn't that right, Keare?"
"Too perfect. How did you come up with that answer? I thought the only one who could notice it was Ellen, but here she is again. And now that the information that Bullet was aware of has been confirmed, we can read Bullet's purpose."
"What do you want me to do again?"
"Oh, Keare, it'll be easy.
Here is the Demon Lord's heart. I'm going to cut it out now."
"No, the Demon Lord and Keare were lovers."
"I'll let you cut it out, and you'll start over. I'll decide when to go back.
3 years ago from now. Not bad, huh? There's only one bad ending from here on out.
If you refuse this offer, I will take care of you and humiliate the women in front of you. You can watch them break, and the humiliation won't end until you cry out for me to stop and beg me to let you use the Philosopher's Stone."
"Well, I suppose that is an option. Bullet will continue to do everything he can until I'm ready, until I despair of everything in the world and crave for that restart button."
"Bullet, I know what you want back, but don't you think that if I rewind time, you'll forget everything, make the same mistakes, and lose it all again?"
"I don't think so."
"If you thought about how you were able to rewind the world and still retain your memories, you could understand the trick to it. I could do the same. I wonder how far out of the norm this is. There is no escape at all. I need a little more time to use my last move."
The preparation was not over yet.
"This move was an accident. It was a reversal move born from my whim. No, maybe Ellen had read that and said that. I was very careful to buy time so that my intentions would not be discovered."
"Hey, Bullet, have you ever wondered why I didn't rip out Eve's heart and start over before we got here?"
"I didn't understand that either."
"If I were you, I wouldn't have tried to play a game where the situation was this bad. I would have just rewounded."
"I think you're right.
You'll be able to go back before you defeat the Demon King and prepare a plan to prevent me from taking the Philosopher's Stone. I thought about it, and Ellen recommended the move. I'll kill Eve and use her heart to rewind."
"Even though it is necessary to kill Eve to rewind time, Eve will come sooner or later," Ellen said. "If you know that Bullet is going to take the Philosopher's Stone after he defeats the Demon King, there are plenty of ways to deal with him. It's the best way to win against Bullet, because even if you rewind time, there are some things you can't get back."
"I'll tell you Bullet's flaw.
He doesn't love people. He's just playing with dolls. Would you like to tell me what that means?
I love people. I love the girls I've spent time with. And after rewinding time, they become strangers with the same form. They are no longer the girls I fell in love with.
If you love a human being, you don't think you can start over and get them back.
So Bullet, all this time you've just been playing with dolls.
Bullet kept his smile taut.
But for the first time today, I felt anger, which I had known for a long time.
Thanks for the advice. Do you want to turn down my offer and stay here and let your women be raped?
No. No, no. I'd rather end their suffering here than put them through hell. It's the least I can do.
He walks over to Bullet. He reached out to Eve's chest, who had her eyes closed.
The signal.
It came, just in time to prepare. It's the last move that can be used only in the worst case scenario, on the verge of defeat. It is too uncertain to even be called a strategy.
Still, I had a feeling that it would work.
Because you see, I have faith in these girls.